What's up, guys? This is Stitch with Black and Black Times Infinity. I want to talk to you about our sponsor that we have this week called Loot Crate. If you guys don't know, Loot Crate is a subscription service that delivers an awesome random surprise to your house on a monthly, 3-month, 6-month, or yearly subscription where you can get some of the coolest random gifts delivered straight to your doorstep. Also, you can get subscribed to Pet Crate, which is a gift service with a pet theme to it. You can get nice dog treats, leashes, dog bowls, collars, and everything. We also have Anime Crate, which has an anime theme to it, WWE Crate, and plenty of other themed subscriptions that Loot Crate offers. To join that, or if you're interested in it, you can go to www.trylootcrate.com/bethanbti and enter the code BRIDGE10, BRIDGE10, and you can save 10% off your subscription service to that. Once again, that's trylootcrate.com/bethanbti and enter the code BRIDGE10, and you can save 10% off your subscription service to Loot Crate. And now, on with the show.
Conan, what is best in life?
To crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and listen to Blacker Than Black Times Infinity. Hey, this is Matt,
Joe,
and Becky,
host of Pre-Recorded Live from The Mistake on the Lake, and you are listening to Blacker Than Black Times Infinity.
There is a story so strange in its implications that it defies ordinary classification.
I don't care if you just realized that Juicy J can't say no to Ratchet Pussy. If you up, smash that like button. Welcome to Blacker Than Black Times Infinity. I'm your host, Cthulhu's Prodigy, coming to you live and direct from the Dro. Smoke me out, fam, with that dang shit on my left. Your boy Stitch.
Supergirl said her pussy was made of steel. Now I might be the man of steel for her.
Oh, I like it. I'm a far right engineer on the one Jews. Show people out on Threes and Fours Chronos.
Cash me outside, see what happens.
Oh, I love that one. That's good shit. In the middle, we got the oldest ninja in the world, old ninja.
You can't be letting motherfuckers disrespect your podcast. They ain't gonna think you sweet out here trying to keep it 92+8 with y'all.
What the fuck? God damn. Dankness all around. And last but not least, we got your boy Blue.
You know what, guys? You guys can all just fuck off. Actually, you know what? I feel kind of bad. You can fuck back on.
God damn.
You know what? Fuck off.
Shit, we back up in this bitch. All right.
Yeah.
Doing it once again.
Yes.
Forming like Voltron.
Ooh.
Who wants some of this beer?
Trump didn't shut us down yet.
No.
Too black, too strong.
Hey, don't say that fucking, what is it? Global warming's real. They fucking shut us down and shit.
Gonna sign an executive order. No smart Negroes.
No uppity Negroes.
Yeah. Hey, he's trying to make America great again, so.
Who taught y'all Octagon?
Hey, he's trying to make America great again. We're trying to make America dank again.
There we go.
Hey, you know what? That should be the title of this podcast.
There we go.
Ooh, Make just America Think Again.
We haven't done that? Damn.
No, we haven't.
We really haven't. That's like so on the nose. All right. Yeah, let's do it. Who's our goddamn motherfucking fan of the week?
That will be D&G Talk Shit. Man. Thank you, fellas. For people that we don't know, it would be Lauren. So thank you both for listening.
We appreciate the fuck out of that, out of them. They got a great cast. If you haven't checked out D&G's Talk Shit podcast, it is awesome. And next time, Daniel definitely needs to give us all an update on Grindr and how he's doing on that.
Yeah, no shit.
God damn.
And actually, let's do something else new.
What you got?
We're going to give a shout-out to the first person that shouts us out in the fucking room.
What you got?
So what's going on, Jason?
Hey, what
Thanks
up,
for
fam?
Watching us live.
What up, what up, what up?
Yay.
All right. Who's going to take us away for them RIPs?
I guess normally I've been doing it. So we had RIP to Miss Mary Tyler Moore.
Why do I know that name?
So she
Buddy Holly song, goddammit. That's how you know
it.
Yeah.
Right.
That not only that, but she's been an iconic comedic figure for decades.
Before our time, not your time.
Yeah. Well, no, it was my time too. I'm the oldest ninja in the world.
I heard you took her to prom.
Smell my fingers. But yeah, she started out, her big breakout role was on the Dick Van Dyke Show.
She took dick for who?
Whoa.
Come on, man. It's got to be respectful.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Right?
I'm sorry.
Shit, not lower. Mary Tyler Moore. And then she managed to get her own show back in the 60s.
That's impressive.
It was the Mary Tyler Moore Show, which was on Saturday night. Her show dominated in ratings, and her show was unstoppable. It is a staple for CBS. A lot of shows have been trying to match her comedic performance or her ratings juggernaut show. It's still legendary to this day. She did a bunch of you know, other movies that didn't do too great. But she did do a comedic movie that was actually nominated for an Oscar back in the day, which was Ordinary People.
Goddamn, ain't nobody seen that shit, bro.
Yeah, but she's done stellar work, and she died at the age of 80 this morning.
Oh, wow.
Why is it that every time we have an RIP, we sort of subtly shit on them?
Yeah.
Like, I'm just noticing, like, a small pattern.
You don't make it out of this life alive.
Oh, no, no. He's like, no, ain't nobody seen that. Lady's dead.
Rest in peace. It's kind of the best way to remember him.
Yeah, that's all.
Nice.
Yeah, you know what's funny? Laugh. If she was here with her 80-year-old ass, she would have roasted the shit out of you.
Yeah. Sure. Like, stop being a bitch.
Yeah. She would have roasted you extra hard.
She's got a fucking song named after her.
It's a fucking tasty beverage, goddammit. Sorry, Blue, what'd you bring?
Oh, getting off. So yeah, over last weekend, I went to Lagunitas. It's a brewery that's based here in California, and it's out in Petaluma.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And we are drinking Imperial Coffee Stout that's been soaked in whiskey barrels. So it's aged in high West Rye whiskey barrels.
We know a percentage on that?
It's
a lot. It sounds like it should be a lot.
Make you blind.
Yeah, so I actually toured the brewery last week. This is a pretty basic brewery tour, but the one thing I didn't like it, which will have all you guys fucking pissed off, is there was no free samples at the end.
God
which
damn
is like, but it was cool.
Pay?
Huh?
That sucks.
Oh, you didn't have to pay for the tour, but there was just no drinking at the end. Like, they didn't have any samples. Usually, some of the breweries, they have samples that you can try.
Yeah.
That's un-American, bro.
Most of the breweries, that's...
Another thing they didn't do, so if you have your own growler, they won't fill your growler. You have to buy one of their growlers.
Mm. Oh, see, that's lame. Like, most places just put a fucking label on it.
Yeah, that's what I said. I was like, yeah, they used to do that, but I guess
they'll only fill out the ones that have their label on it.
Yeah, only ones that have their logo on there.
That's.
But it's a pretty cool fucking bottle, though. Like, it has their dog on it. Yeah. On the side, it says there's like different levels. It says drink me, and add beer. Little to share. The glass is half full, plenty to share, and party time.
I like it.
For the different levels.
So here's a fun little fact about Lagunitas. It's actually... So back in the day, they used to have a beer called something like the Chronic or some shit like
that. Yeah, it's called Chronic. They told that story.
Yeah, so basically they had this beer called Chronic, and it used to be widely known that you can go to Lagunitas and basically just smoke weed.
Wow.
And so we were doing that all the fucking time. And so they sent a cop over there to see it, because technically it's not, I mean, it's sort of illegal, but not really. You can't really arrest somebody for, especially if you have, you know, a cannabis card for smoking weed. But apparently, the cops really wanted to bust them, so they sent a cop over there to go undercover bust them, right?
Okay.
To see, they were trying to get somebody to sell them weed. So eventually somebody did, because they kept asking. Somebody sold
them weed. Who worked there?
No, just somebody just happened to be there.
Patrons?
Yeah. And so after that happened, they shut the whole fucking place down.
What? And so, are you sitting me?
Yeah.
How long ago was this?
It was like a couple years back.
And so they haven't been around that long. Yeah. Like Nita's.
Oh, and really?
So after they reopened, they renamed the Chronic beer. I think it was Undercover Shutdown.
Mm. Oh, no. So,
after
that happened, they released a beer called the Undercover Shutdown. But the Chronic one, it's still called Chronic. So
it's like Censored or something like that, right?
Yes, it's called Censored now. But basically for the Chronic one, they were trying to ship outside of California, and they had to like go through like some kind of custom things or whatever. And they spelled Chronic with the K backwards, and I guess it kind of almost got through. But like one of the interns was like, "Hey, you're gonna actually let that go through?" He's like, "Yeah." He's like, "You know what Chronic is, right?" He's like, "Yeah, that's like." He's like, "No." He's like, and the guy was like, "Yeah, that's street for weed." And so the guy's like, "Oh no, we're not gonna fucking do this." So for them to get around it, they just went to, instead of them remaking new labels, they just put a censor label over the Chronic. But what's funny is that the guy was saying
still
that
to this day.
Yeah, they still have it to this day. But if you look at the logo back when they first did it to the logo this day, the logo for censor is getting smaller and smaller, so you can see the Chronic behind it better and better.
Can we show the folks in the chat what he's describing?
Check out that sounds awesome. Yeah.
But what's also funny about it is that. Like the owner of Lagunitas is like, what the, like, how are you censoring that? It's like, don't you know, like, bud? You know what bud is, right?
Yeah.
Like, bud is fucking weed.
True.
What is it? Miller's High Life? Come on now. Like, what the fuck?
It's like, we'll talk about chronic pain, goddammit.
Yeah. It's beer to ease your pain.
There you go. I like it. Yeah. If we can get a visual, that'd be awesome. But, oh, okay. I see it. Yeah. Censored, huh?
Yeah. So it's called Censored, but like, the guy was saying the logo's getting, so the third picture that you're near right now.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the original logo.
Yeah.
I see. But like, you can see how like the logo is getting smaller and smaller for censored.
So that's the original. This is what I'm used to seeing. Is this one right here?
Yep.
And then I guess the one that.
So the one
you're talking about, yeah, it's getting smaller and smaller. It's right here.
Yeah, so you can kind of see the chronic behind it.
Yeah.
Right there. Yeah.
That's cool. That's really cool.
I didn't know that had a history behind it. That's really interesting.
Yeah, the owner was is a well-known smoker of the chronic.
The weeds.
Yeah. But it was a cool story. You know, they had really good drinks there. And they had this one beer that would give the Campfire Stout a run for its fucking money, dude.
Ooh.
Really?
It was so goddamn good. But they didn't sell it in the... You couldn't take it home, so that kind of sucked. Could get a growler of it.
I'm about to make a trip up there.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's surprisingly, it's like maybe an hour away.
And also, if you go up there, like, hit up Russian River as well. Russian River, and there's another one.
That's Russian River is good. Bear Republic's got their thing up there.
Yeah, Sierra Nevada's not that far from there. And then there's... What's the other one? There's a really cool bar called Hot Monk that's up there.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty nice, too.
Or, but yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's in Sebastopol, though.
Yeah, that whole Hedensburg area is legit. Yeah.
Why don't we segue into SF Beer Week a little bit? Because we were talking about beer.
Shit, I was going to say something, but I forgot. Never mind.
All right. Well, SF Beer Week is upon us. It's going to be here in about 2 weeks.
2 weeks. I'm excited.
And I'm taking my annual beercation, taking the whole week off. So, yeah, I've already updated my itinerary. So I have, Friday, we're doing the opening gala. I think we're all going to be there, right? Yeah.
Yes.
You coming too?
No.
Not old Ninja?
Because he's too old. I'll be there at the gala.
All right.
I'll probably do this Saturday, whatever the next day I saw on there.
Okay. I have an itinerary for Monday, and I'm making one for Tuesday since I'm not going to celebrate Valentine's Day on Valentine's Day. So, I'm going to keep adding to it. So I have Monday's pretty full. So.
Have you tweeted it out or posted it or something?
I tweeted out my itinerary, but I didn't tweet out exactly which ones I'm going to. You have to click on my itinerary, but I can post where I'll be on what day.
Good shit.
It's going to be cool. The food pairing ones are always fucking cool.
Yeah, let's do the, there's one on Sunday I said I wanted to go to, right? It's beer and pancakes.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah, I saw that.
Count me in.
That's in the city.
You said beer, right?
That one's in Oakland.
You had a Homer Simpson type moment. beer.
Well, it's $15 to get in unlimited pancakes, so.
That's kind of crazy.
Oh, that's a great way to start off a day. It's in the morning, right?
Yeah, okay, it's brunch. Yeah. And then I think
it starts at 11, yeah?
It starts at 10. Oh, and then, so they have that, and then later on that, well, at the same time, between 10 and 2, because they're both brunches. It's a place called The Social in San Francisco that's having their strong beer with food pairing. So that's going to be a good one. Because I took you to The Social one time, right?
Mm-hmm.
The pork belly fucking
fried rice. It was
pork
an amazing
belly fried
meal.
Rice?
Yeah, it's fucking really good.
Yeah,
that sounds amazing already.
What was that one place you went to last year? The Blueprint or something like that?
Yeah, I went there.
That place
was
real fucking good.
And that place is new.
Yeah.
Was that the place you went to?
No, we went to the 55
South?
Yeah.
Is that it?
You're talking about the barbecue place?
The place with the barbecue or whatnot?
The place is good.
And we had to sit outside in the fucking rain?
Yeah.
They had good-ass food, but...
But Magnolia had good-ass food, too.
Got it,
That place is, legit.
Oh, okay, California. Yeah. I heard about that.
Oh, that's why you weren't here last year. No. We almost fucked up, because... We went there and they had these beer flights.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I remember you guys talking about it on the cast, and you guys got annihilated because it was a whiskey flight or something.
Well, it was
right?
Whiskey and beer.
Yeah.
So
and it wasn't like a small little ounce. It was fucking a 3 ounce. Shot of it.
God, and that's when, wasn't your niece vomiting.
That was another day. That shit was fucking hilarious though. Yeah, she vomited. She was throwing up, and I didn't even know because we were drinking all day. And then, at the last, our second last stop, she kept getting up to go to the bathroom. I was like, oh, make sure we had to pee.
Yeah.
And then, later on, she's like, oh, yeah, I was just throwing up. I was just like, holy shit, could have slowed the fuck down.
You guys interviewed the Uber driver, too.
Yeah.
A couple Uber drivers.
That was fucking great. That was really cool.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I was talking with the professor the other day about how I was looking forward to SF Beer Week for, over 2 years coming. last year, when I was out here, I was out here and I was leaving the week before. Or something, so I just missed it and shit. So I'm looking forward to this. I'm gonna have to train my body with lots of vitamins and
it tails the season.
Gatorade and
he had it down on lock. He knew where to go, what time to be there. He it was like his third job.
Great. Do you have any days off during SFP week?
I put in a request. Well, I made sure I requested off for the gala. And then I could probably maneuver some shit around everything.
One more time, give the listeners the actual dates, the hard dates.
Yeah,
the 10th is the gala?
Yeah, it's the 10th through the 19th.
Okay, great.
February. So, and there's multiple events on all those days, except for like the first day. There's really no events except for the gala.
Mm-hmm.
But we can make like a day. Like I haven't been to HRD in a long time. That's a really good place. You ever been there?
And HRD?
Like, yeah, it's like a Korean place, like fusion sort of.
Oh,
and diner like with like kimchi burritos.
It's fucking good as shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I might make a day out of that.
And just keep our fingers crossed the weather is, this rain finally stops.
Rain or shine. That's a beer.
I'm
a beer.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
I'll get some galoshes.
Fucking bring a fucking canoe.
Exactly.
Fucking paddle in.
Last year was storming. We still was out there. We sat in the rain and ate.
No matter.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, we recorded in the rain because like we're on that one patio.
Zeitgeist fucking loves Zeitgeist.
Yeah, yeah, that was
it's
good.
One of the best bars in America.
Oh yeah, I did see that. Yeah,
and we did that. And
going there the other day.
That's where we fucking met. What's the name of the band we talked to? Shit, what's the name of the band?
Oh, you're talking about goddamn Jay Trees.
Yeah,
oh, okay. Trees later that night.
Yeah, I met Jay Trees later. With Drunk Blue trying to take down a fucking number. Loud ass fucking.
You asked him like 15 times. Yeah. So what was after 7? Or you know, anyway.
I think I still have a number in my phone. But also coming up, or it's in March, but there's another beer fest that I'm going to with Professor X and some friends from Apple.
God damn.
Yeah, Drunk Blue's gonna be in a fucking effect.
God damn.
I'm waiting, man. Because on my Facebook,
I'm so confused. You said Professor X. Mr. X and the Professor.
Mr. X.
Okay. Okay.
It's a combination. They did a fusion.
Yeah,
they did.
I was like Charles Xavier.
Because I'm going with Mr. X, and I don't know if the Professor's going too.
Okay.
So, but yeah, we're going with some Apple friends. But, you know, dude, fucking, what's up with Concord's Winter Brewfest? Did they just cancel the winter one and just made it spring?
Well, I know last year they couldn't have it because it was during the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And it was like the weather sucked. And then this year. Might be the same thing.
Yeah, because I was looking on my Facebook timeline or whatever. It showed like, oh, on this day you're drinking like 80 different kind of beers. I'm like, no, that sounds like it was a Winter Brewfest. But you should see my fucking timeline on.
it's all fucked up. It looks like I'm an alcoholic.
You know what? One thing I hope that a lot of breweries start doing because with the what's the name of that drinking app?
Untappd.
Yeah, Untappd. They have a feature on it now where you can scan the barcode. Yeah. Of like a bottle, and you can check it in that way.
Oh wow, okay.
And I wish that a lot of people or a lot of the sampler stands had like a barcode where you can just simply just go up and scan it, and then just check in the beer.
Hmm. I'm gonna need to buy like a battery pack
because it's fun. Because like in the beginning you're fine because you can type and shit, but once you're like an hour up, into it,
time gets tough.
Yeah,
time gets tough, and you're just fuck it. It all seems the same at this point anyway.
Holy shit!
Hilarious.
So beer,
yeah,
drink it, love it, tastes great.
But yeah, if you guys do SF Beer Week, the best thing isn't. So if you do it, don't go to just one event a day. You got to go up to like at least 3 places. That's what I like to do is at least 3 a day.
Yeah.
Because then you go from one, you drink, and then you usually drink a little bit too much, start getting your buzz on, and you go to the next place, you sober up a little bit, and then you start drinking again. And then it's all right. But if you just stay at one place and drink all fucking day, you can have a bad fucking day.
So. And just to put this out there, there's Uber being taken and public transit. We're not driving around, So
I take Bart to Uber Black because that's how I roll.
Black as shit.
Yeah, because we black and they're black.
Yeah.
There we go. So what are we jumping into? What about the Star Wars news?
Star Wars: The Last Motherfucking Jedi.
Yeah, there's a lot. It's weird because I thought it was pretty cut and dry, but then everyone's all like talking about all these theories and shit about what The Last Jedi means. Because like in the Star Wars universe, Jedi is both singular and plural. So people were like, does this mean...
I didn't think about that.
Yeah, I didn't think about that either. Actually, there's some pretty interesting breakdowns. The best one I've seen so far was on Nerdist, how they talked about, Luke may not be the last Jedi.
Well, we all know he's not.
Yeah. So, we also thought... Not. Well, back in the original trilogy, there was Yoda as well as Luke, so...
Tell us, who's alive after Force Awakens besides Luke in terms of Jedi?
There's a shitload of Jedi that didn't die after Order 66. Like, true. A lot.
Oh,
well, okay. There's some that we don't know their actual fate, but we do know that they survived Order 66.
Like, and they're just out in the universe.
I think Ahsoka didn't die, right?
Ahsoka did. Well, you're not watching Star Wars Rebels.
Yeah, no. She's still alive, though, right?
She is still alive for now. Mm. Her fate so far is uncertain. So she does appear in Star Wars Rebels. She actually. Shows up with like really like obscure lore that people were talking about a gray Jedi. So she actually changes her lightsabers to be white.
Wow.
So she has dual lightsabers that are white. So she does not, and she also publicly states that she's not a Jedi.
Yeah, I saw her fight. I saw the Darth Vader fight.
Yeah.
Oh, did she become a gray?
Yeah, I guess technically she's a gray. She has Jedi training, but she does not claim to be a Jedi.
Yeah, she was. She was trained. Sorry, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, for those that don't know, like, there's another Forcer wielder out there. They're called the Gray. I don't know all the details behind them, but I know there's the Sith, the Jedi, and then the gray, which are more like the peaceful, like, we don't fight type of people, like Buddhists.
Well, they're not really Buddhist. They use both sides of the Force. That's why they're gray. Because they use Force lightning and shit like that traditionally for the dark side.
So basically, it's like a religion. They don't choose either religion, but they have fighting skills for both. Yeah, kind of like that.
Wow.
So they don't really have a true allegiance, except basically to protect themselves and be in their own interest. But they don't necessarily, like, are aggressive. They just make sure that they defend.
And just to speculate, people are talking about potentially seeing some of that in Episode 8?
No idea.
Okay.
People are talking about there might be more Jedi. Like, this, there's speculation that the term Jedi may go away.
Mm, okay.
So how there's the Knights of Ren from Force Awakens, because there's no Sith.
Yeah.
So they're saying that the term Jedi may transform into something different due to Luke's teachings.
Can't wait. I don't even want to know per se more, even though I do want to catch up on Rebels. Mm. But yeah, I'm just fucking down for it, no matter fucking what.
Yeah, I mean, I'm good now. I do want to see at least a trailer, which we haven't seen as of yet.
But not too long on the trailer.
Yeah, I don't want too much. But then again, Force Awakens didn't give us a whole lot. It gave me enough to want to watch it.
Nutting in your fucking pants.
I was nutting all day. But I'm curious to know what role Benicio del Toro has. Mm. So that should be
a good point.
He's going to be the collector.
Collecting lightsabers. You should give me your lightsaber.
You know what? It's all owned by Disney. You never know.
Yeah, you never know.
So the reason why I brought up Ahsoka is because she's, I believe, the only person that Anakin trained.
Mm.
So she's pretty important.
If they keep the secret apprentice thing, which they kind of took elements of, then she would be the first, and then the Galen Malik would be the second. That's if he's technically canon, and it's still uncertain if he is or not.
And that's the guy from the Force Unleashed game, right?
Yeah. So, but the thing is, I don't think he is canon anymore, because in Rogue One, Galen Erso is kind of a pull or a play from Galen Malik, who was the original apprentice. So.
Oh, like they stole part of his name and identity?
Yeah, so usually in the Star Wars universe, everybody has a singular name. Most names are not used twice, with the exception of Ben. Ben's the only one that's been used twice. Ooh. So,
all right.
We don't know.
Is there any other news oh, God damn, I'm so bad with fucking names.
You've been drinking, bro.
Yeah.
The guy who drives the Millennium Falcon. Han Solo.
He dead, bro.
I know he's dead, but they're making a solo movie.
Oh, yes. They're doing a solo movie, yes.
Yeah, Han Solo's doing a movie, and they're going to be... They've cast somebody, right?
Woody Harrelson to be in the movie.
Oh, I know. That's what it was.
Yeah, just to clear it up, they're not saying that he's Han.
No, they're not saying that he's Han.
Yeah.
They haven't actually officially released the character's name or his role as of yet.
I like Woody in almost everything, though.
Yeah, that'll be interesting.
You like Wood?
You like him in Toy Story too?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's just gonna be drunk and high during the whole movie and like shooting.
He's gonna play Haymitch again?
Yeah, pretty much in a Star Wars uniform. Be like, "What's up, fools?" Blah 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 blah. That'll be interesting.
So, God damn! All right,
shoot first. Maybe he has a fake hand like the big. Was it the big? Not Big Lebowski.
The bowling movie with Bill Murray. God damn!
Was
hilarious.
Was it? Well, that was Big Lebowski.
Bill Murray's
one. Oh, Kingpin.
There you go. With the save.
I never even watched that movie. I just knew it. Really? It's actually pretty funny. I watched The Big Lebowski, though.
I've seen The Big Lebowski a few times, and it has a super cult following.
Oh, that's a great
movie. Yeah. I actually watched that for the first time, like, maybe, like, a year or two ago.
God damn.
It's pretty funny.
It's one of those things that, like, I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, I was like,
White Russians. Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. Caucasians. I'll take a Caucasian. There's a lot of trailers that dropped out.
Okay.
Yes, indeed.
We want to talk about
that. I have not watched the Logan trailer, like the latest one.
Woo!
Oh, man, it's good.
I already know, like, I mean, it's going to have X-23 in it, right? So that's all I need to know.
I didn't like the very first trailer, per se, and I'm real tentative about anything having to do with the X-Men, just because I think Fox has just completely fucked up that entire franchise. This one was really good. I really liked this trailer. It didn't try to walloped me over the head with trying to be like all dark and somber, yeah. but it still had those notes that let me know that it was serious and it wasn't just all sort of kiddie running
like
around
a
type stuff.
Fucking interview.
It was really good. Like I was taken aback by it. Like I didn't even really want to watch it at first. I was just like, oh god, whatever, blah blah blah. And I checked it out. I was like, okay. I was like, this trailer is cut really really well. But like I said before, that's just a trailer, and
you can be
fooled easily on a good trailer in relation to how the movie's actually going to turn out.
It's true.
I plan on seeing this one.
Oh yeah.
I mean, I've seen them, basically all of them or whatever. Yeah. But
that girl's legit
badass.
She's just stabbing people and chopping off arms and shit.
So we get a visual confirmation that this is X-23.
Yes.
I mean, I think most people should have known.
Yeah. But
was she in the first trailer? Because I don't remember seeing her.
She is in the first trailer.
Show her, but
you don't see her claws and you do in this one.
She better
actually see people get her rip throats out.
They better have that trigger scent. If they don't, be pissed.
A breakdown of the trigger sense.
The trigger sense is what makes her go basically fucking crazy.
She
could kill Wolverine crazy.
Mm.
So,
goddamn.
Yeah, the people, they still, even to this day, they're exploiting that.
Okay.
They just drop that scent. It's like she just goes on a murderous rampage. Mm.
X-23, she's the clone of Wolverine, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
So
it looked pretty good.
It did look pretty interesting.
The only thing I didn't like is I just don't like the wire work that they do in terms of like how like when Wolverine's like jumping. It just looks so ridiculously fake. Like, I don't know what the Marvel MCU does differently than Fox in terms of like how they do their stunts and everything. Well, like Thor flying around looks much more believable and jumping around, or even when Captain Cap is jumping around, it looks like okay, it's coming from his legs. It's not like all of a sudden he's just like being lifted by a harness and flying like Wolverine.
I want to say they do more CGI for the jumping parts, because I know there's like one behind the scenes where they're like jumping off the bridge, and it's pretty much like I think it's CGI to a certain point, and then they're like on
landing
platforms and they're just jumping.
It looks a lot better than what they're doing with this whole Fox
thing. You know why? Because Disney owns Industrial Light and Magic.
That's true.
So they're one of the top VFX houses in the world.
Well, I still like the more practical versions of it, right? Like I think Christopher Nolan does a really good job of doing things like that, because he uses real things. Like if you watch Inception, when the room starts turning, he actually created that room and he just turned the whole fucking thing.
Yeah.
And they had all to act while it was turning.
Or all three Batman movies, I was going to say, too. But yeah. What other trailers?
So we had the Power Ranger full-length trailer.
I didn't watch that one, but I heard that was pretty good.
That one had me hyped.
People are supposedly hyped about this Power Ranger.
Yeah, there's actually a little racial joke that's pretty funny, because like
with the yellow?
End up in the water, and in the water it shows like the color that they're supposed to be. Yeah. And so one of them is a white dude. He's like, hey, I'm black. And the black dude's like, no, you're not. He's like, yeah. He's like, no, you ain't, man. It's hella funny.
That's good.
And then so we finally see Zordon for the first time.
No, I think about to say hard on.
Is he selling meth?
No, he is good though. We don't know.
Is that what gets him to be the Power Rangers?
That's awesome. And then we also see Alpha 5.
It's the kind of candy you smoke from a pipe.
Yeah, so
we also got to see him transform into their suit, which is kind of cool.
But we saw that before. But we actually see their Zords. We actually see Rita Repulsa kicking motherfucking ass.
She's fucking scary as fuck, dude.
She's no fucks. Throwing people, fucking choking people out. I was like, holy shit.
Well, that's kind of funny, because in the show, she's not really
hands-on. She's not really physical.
No,
yeah.
Goldar and the other guy.
So here's the thing. Goldar is a giant Zord, I guess, in this. And he's all gold. So
wait,
that was kind of weird.
Wait, was that the gorilla looking
the gorilla guy?
Yeah, he's like a man griffin.
Yeah,
that guy.
When does this drop?
In March, I think, also. There's a shit ton of movies.
Oh, that's right around the corner.
Yeah, so we have, Logan, I think, in March. We have
that's in March also? Damn.
Yeah, we have that. We have Kong Skull Island in March, Power Rangers,
the Switch drops.
The Switch comes out. Mass Effect's coming out that month.
March is a big month. But what about Wonder Woman? Is March, too, right?
Or
is that May?
May?
I could be fucking that up. Sorry.
Yeah, I think that's a summer thing. But there's I know there's probably a huge movie every week in March.
Okay.
Good. That'll.
Well, what's funny is it seems like the big budget, like popcorn movies, action movies, used to start early.
Yeah,
they used to start like Memorial Day weekend and go all the way through Labor Day weekend.
Yeah, but it's starting. It looks like they're starting super.
Yeah, they're starting. Normally they start like late April, beginning of May.
Yep.
And everything, because it's just like it always seems to be that way. I just know because my birthday is right around then. It's like, oh, yeah. Civil War coming out. Spider-Man's coming out.
What you got, Carnage?
Just fucked me up because it said, like, the first thing that came up was God of War movie. But it's not the God of War movie. It says the film was a story of how a Chinese general defeated the Japanese something. So,
oh, that ain't Kratos.
Dare you. Is that the one that's like the Great Wall of China?
No, that one.
No, that's just called The Wall.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Great Wall. So yeah, we have Logan, Kong Skull Island. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a big one. Beauty and the Beast is going to be big no matter what. Chips, Power Rangers.
Chips looks
pretty funny. Like the Highway Patrol ship.
Have you seen the trailer?
I haven't seen the trailer.
Looks pretty funny. It's the dude from Ant-Man, the Hispanic actor. Oh, the one that tells the great stories.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Michael Pena.
Yeah. He's like, oh, my friend of a friend. And he's a friend.
What else you got?
We also have Life, The Boss Baby.
Wait a minute, Life?
Yeah, it's a science fiction and space and shit.
That shit had Eddie Murphy and Martin
Lawrence.
I was
about to say the same thing. I was confused for a second.
And Ghost in a Shell comes out on March 31st.
Yes, oh, that's the other one.
Damn.
I knew there was one.
Wow, that's right around the corner.
March is going to have hella big ass movies.
Whew. Oh, you're right. Okay, so Wonder Woman's more like May then.
Yeah, it's got to be May.
God damn.
That's going to be nice.
What else trailer?
Didn't some other trailer drop this week?
Yeah, I'm trying to think. What else did we miss?
They're making another fucking Smurfs movie? How dare you?
Actually, I saw the trailer for it last night.
Is this the third one?
Yes. Oh, yeah. So,
Smurfs
this
the Lost Village, where they leave the village and go on. They're supposed to go look for, like, the
more
original
Smurfs.
Leave that.
The Fate of the Furious comes out in April, so I'm going to watch that. It's my guilty pleasure.
Yeah, I'm seeing that, too.
There's a, what's the name, Sword Art Online movie coming out soon.
Oh, animated or live action?
Animated.
Okay.
Animated.
Oh, shit, and May Guardians of the Galaxy 2 comes out.
Yeah. That May is when it comes.
Yeah, May is when the heavy hitters.
Yeah,
or more heavy
like
hitters.
We here now.
Yeah. Alien comes out.
Yes,
New Pirates of the Caribbean and Baywatch.
Wait, so is the Alien the Prometheus sequel?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
It's Alien Covenant. Yeah. It is a direct sequel.
And Wonder Woman does not come out in May.
Really?
The fuck, does that come out?
Is it June?
June then. Yeah
it's June. First week that's June. A big one too. It's gonna be. Shitty. Oh, it's gonna be Wonder Woman, Captain Underpants, The Mummy
Kid Book,
Cars 3, All Eyes on Me. It's gonna be
Transformers is later that month.
Yeah, Transformers is garbage.
It still makes money, but whatever.
$1 billion.
Despicable Me is gonna make a lot of money.
I didn't mind any of those movies. The Despicable Me movies were all right.
Yeah, they're pretty fun.
I love those.
Yeah. I didn't dig the Minion one as much, but the first two are the Despicable.
Oh man, the Minion one had me fucking rolling.
Really? All right, we staying on some movies?
I mean,
stuff?
Since we're on movies, you want to touch a little bit on these Oscar nominations?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sticking on the silver screen.
Well, before we go into the actual nominations, I fucking called this shit last year. I said last year, because there was no black nominations, the next year, which is this year, they're going to go fucking overboard with all of the nominations of African Americans. That's exactly what they fucking did. There is not one fucking category where there isn't somebody fucking black in that shit.
Pretty much.
And it's fucking ridiculous. You went full of nobody. Fuck you, Hollywood.
Like, how many black movies? They got, like, Tyler Perry movies in there and shit?
No. Tyler Perry.
They put that Madea bullshit on. Yeah, I don't know.
Madea Boo for Best Comedy?
No.
Well, so, historical black movie.
I think was it Best Supporting Actress has 3 out of 4 nominations.
Really?
Wow. Yeah, it's like Octavia Spencer's in there.
I think
2 other chicks.
2 or 3 of them are from Hidden Figures.
Yeah,
I believe
that movie. Is
pull it up with the nominees.
Got a lot of nominees on it. The Fences movie, which I don't think anyone of us has seen yet.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I know there was a lot of really good, you know, black movies that came out last year, but. All those nominations, though, I don't think that, like, it's too many for 30% of the population to have that many fucking nominations.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly.
The only one I saw was Hidden Figures, and I talked about that last week. I really enjoyed that one. But Henry, Bunnyman, saw Moonlight and really was raving about that
Which
one.
Yeah.
I mean, Moonlight was the one with Cottonmouth in it.
Yeah,
why the fuck is Henry blacker than us?
Yeah, exactly.
I'm gonna ask him a black.
I did hear that Moonlight was an exceptional movie.
Yeah, and Janelle Monáe's in that one too.
Supposedly
that
musical is getting like a shit ton of money.
That looks like dog shit, bro.
Yeah, it does look like dog shit.
I'm not a musical guy.
Not me either.
But
that's I love my Gwen Stacy though.
That's what I hear. Yeah. But people who have seen it are like, "This is actually a really good movie." And I
kind of
like
it.
So
I gotta dig, and I kind of dig musicals. Like I like I saw
Give Me Your Man Card. Give Me Your Man Card right now.
Idol shit right now.
Yeah,
stop that. that.
No, I saw. I'm just kidding. Right. Those days over. I saw Mamma Mia. That was really good. I saw both the play and the movie. I thought it was pretty decent.
I Need Your Man. So
that's actually the only one.
Do you have like a favorite musical just off the top of your head?
Mary Poppins. Say it.
Aladdin.
Okay. Damn it.
The Aladdin musical is fucking great.
All right. Just, wait, just curious.
But that's not different from the animated movie.
Yeah, it's different than animated.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Chicago is a musical, right?
Yes. Okay. I haven't seen that. So check it out.
Chicago.
Best performance by an actress in a supporting role. There are three nominees that are African-American out of five.
Say what they are.
So Viola Davis for Fences, Octavia Spencer for Hidden Figures, Naomi Harris for Moonlight, and then there's Nicole Kidman and Michelle Williams.
Damn.
Those round out the nominees. So I just saw Hidden Figures last night.
Oh, you did really see it?
Good. Yeah, I just saw it last night. So there's a snub, though. So Taraji, she's not nominated. And she carries that movie. Everybody else is nominated but her.
Janelle got a nomination?
No. I'm just saying.
Janelle stole the show.
She should have. But yeah, she's not nominated for Best Actress. Even though Hidden Figures couldn't is nominated.
Couldn't even say Taraji. See, we're all fucking this shit.
Yeah.
I bet you Buddy Man could have done it. Yeah. But Hidden Figures is nominated for Best Picture.
Yeah. All right.
So is Moonlight.
And then I saw people were upset that Deadpool didn't get nominated.
Yeah, that's kind of a stretch, though. But I mean, the fact that it was actually talked about is a win in my book.
It's not enough.
It's hard to get a comic book.
It's hard to get a comic book movie, especially an R-rated comic book
movie. Well, okay, but hold on now. Hold on now. Remember, just last year, Mad Max got nominated.
Yeah, but
and even though it's not comic book related, that's an action movie.
It's a comic book, though.
Yeah, but Gladiator.
Well, yeah, but I mean, it's like it's super action movie.
Gladiator was an action movie, and that won Best Picture.
But I'm just saying, last year, if it's good enough.
Last year, too, wasn't there like a movie that was put in like the best comedy category that wasn't a fucking comedy?
Golden Globes.
It was The Martian, goddammit. Yeah. It was fucking bullshit. Yeah. It was the best comedy or musical, and it was neither.
Yeah, there was. I think they played like maybe two or three songs, and that was it. But it's like a fucking album soundtrack.
So my issue is fucking Arrival is nominated for
you hated
several,
that
God.
One,
dude. It's a fucking run of the mill goddamn fucking Travelers is better than this fucking movie. Travelers, the TV show, is better than Arrival. I'm sorry.
Is it like Contact? Remember that movie with
No, it's not like Contact.
Contact was fucking good ass movie.
I wish it was as good as Contact, but
damn,
so, yeah. Contact was like a
you should on that one.
Yeah, so. What I would have done is pulled all their nominations and just nominate Amy Adams for her stellar performance. Everything else is fucking shit. I don't know why people are riding this movie's nuts.
You know what's getting me, though? It's literally all of, like, the superhero movies and animated movies that held Hollywood down this year in terms of, like, making all
money?
The fucking money. You would not have studios that were even able financially to make some of these smaller movies without huge billion-dollar successes like
especially
Civil
Disney.
War and, Zootopia and Moana and all these others.
Yeah, but Disney been had money.
Yeah, but this was their best year. I think 2016 was one of their best years financially ever.
And it'll probably, mainly because,
they had like
2016.
Four movies came out last year.
Yeah, but then they, the end of 2015, they were still seeing revenue from The Force Awakens.
Agreed.
So, but then they dropped Rogue One. But they also dropped Civil War.
Yep.
They also dropped
Moana,
Doctor Strange, Moana.
But don't you think some of that extreme money that they made from all of these billion-dollar movies helped, fund?
Yeah, it helps everything. But they have studios where they can do, like,
holy shit, you know what I'm realizing right now? I didn't watch a single fucking movie that's up for business.
No, when I looked at it, I was at the same reaction.
One.
I was like,
I just did a
shoulder shrug.
List them all. You said L.A.,
so
La La Land.
It's Arrival, Fences, Hacksaw Ridge, Hell or High Water, Hidden Figures, La La Land, Lion, Manchester by Sea, and Moonlight. Some of those I haven't even fucking heard of. So,
me neither.
BCA, hey, what's going on, Victor? Thanks for watching.
What up?
He's asking, you say, hey, what's going on, guys? You said Deadpool was his movie of the year, including movies not nominated. What would we put at the top?
Ooh.
Look at the Golden Eggplant.
Well, yeah,
Golden Eggplant kind of summarized.
That's what we voted on.
I really enjoyed that movie, Eye in the Sky, with
talking about
drones and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
That I thought that was really, really, really good. I think I watched it maybe like 2 weeks ago, so it was after our Golden Eggplants Awards. But that was really good with the Jesse from Breaking Bad, and then I can't think of the female actress.
And she's in that movie, Red.
She's the bitch lady. I'm trying to think of the other drone pilot that's with Jesse. But it was really good. It was really compelling. I highly recommend that. That was really, really good.
I will say this. I do want to see Spider-Man in the war movie or whatever, Hacksaw Ridge or whatever. Andrew Garfield is in that one.
What the fuck are you talking about? Yeah.
Yeah. Spider-Man. That's my Spider-Man. Andrew Garfield. He's in that one. I want to see that one. It seems like I like some more movies.
I want to see one.
Wait a minute. That was in Hacksaw Ridge.
Yeah, it's the guy who didn't go to war. You know what's funny about that?
Interesting.
It might have been true, but you can't do that nowadays. Well, I guess you sort of can. It's very difficult for you to go in the military unless you're in like a specific medical role.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're not going to let you go out there with no fucking weapon.
Yeah, that would make sense.
And they're not going to let you be a conscientious objector like that. Objector like that?
Objector.
Like the Marine Corps, they'll just kick you out.
You mean they don't got the guy playing the drums on the front line?
The guy with the drums has a fucking gun. Just getting
shot at. But this was like World War II, I believe, for this one.
It's in the army, though. Let's go for it. I think he's in the army.
I think so, yeah. So
I thought that guy got a free pass, though. We could shoot at him.
Yeah, right?
No, you shoot his ass first. You give him a fucking morale.
Exactly.
Bring morale down first.
It's like in what's it called? Fucking
in a Bugs Bunny cartoons?
No, god damn it!
Comedian.
What movie were we just talking about with the fucking trucks with the fucking band?
Mad Max.
Where he's just remember me. Yeah, you just knock out that guy, kills all the morale.
Oh shit! Do you have Alexa plugged in?
Yeah.
So you know what? I think we kind of fucked up with our nominations for Celebrity of the Year. We didn't nominate your boy Cottonmouth. We talked about it. Yeah.
But, you know, his role in, at least in Luke Cage.
You didn't like him in Luke Cage.
I didn't like him.
But he's in a bunch of other shit.
I thought he was amazing.
We haven't really seen the other stuff, though.
Guys, check the show.
Maybe because I'm biased.
Hold on.
Watch. Alexa, witness me.
I can't find the answer.
I got it. Hold on. Alexa, witness me.
May you ride eternal, shiny, and chrome.
Yeah!
Oh, gosh. Yeah. Dude, I need to see that movie again.
Rome!
She was so fucking awesome.
See, but then you were like, oh, Mad Max got nominated. Well, of course, because it was amazing.
It was amazing.
But there's like no fucking story to it, though.
It was amazing.
Can we get back to Victor's point?
You know, a movie I saw last year.
I thought we answered Victor.
No, we didn't.
I answered Victor. You clowns didn't yet.
So, like, this movie wasn't available. I don't think it went to the theater. It's like a direct to DVD or whatever. It was a movie called Mr. Church, and it's the one with Eddie Murphy in it. And it's really good. So basically, he plays a cook, and like, there's a mom. I can't remember her name, but she's dying of cancer, and she hooked up with some like guy who's already married, and she only had like 3 months to live, and so he hired Mr. Church to cook for her and her daughter until she died or whatever, and then like he could leave and stuff like that. But like the woman ended up living like a couple of more years, and like just the whole story behind it is actually really cool and has like a cool ending at the end. It was a really good Eddie Murphy movie, to be honest.
So you would like that?
I would like to see that as the Golden Globe thingy or whatever.
Not for the Golden Globes.
Or wait a minute.
We're talking about the Oscars, goddammit.
Sorry. Fucking award. Yeah.
What you got?
I still really want to see Deadpool up there. Sorry, it was a great movie, and it was. I understand that it's not like highbrow fucking artistic work, but it was genius the way that it made fun of itself, made fun of the viewers. You know, especially on the budget, did a fucking great job.
Oh, yeah. And what's also cool with it is that, like, I think it's one of the first, like, comic book movies where the characters wearing a mask, but the mask actually make gestures and stuff, which is very true to the comic book.
Yeah.
I mean, to just not name anything that's already been named, maybe Doctor Strange. I mean, it had great visuals, you know? So
I still got to see that on Wii.
I got to watch that high, yeah.
Yeah.
For special effects, I wonder if that got nominated.
I don't know.
Rogue One did.
Meryl Streep said that's for the peasants. peasants don't matter.
I actually really like Hidden Figures. I think Hidden Figures does belong up there. I just saw it, so maybe I'm coming out that high, but I think it was a great story to tell about actual people that did things back in the day and that were fighting for civil rights in their workplace and in their home lives as well. It was a great story.
Am I gonna? Okay, maybe I'm just gonna just
say it.
Be Debbie Down or whatever.
What you got?
Why is it that like can we get like a black movie that doesn't have to directly do it like civil rights?
Thank you. I would say this.
Like, I mean,
if that's the case, then I say watch Moonlight.
I don't even know what Moonlight's about.
Moonlight seems to be about it seems like it has gay black community modern times themes to it.
Okay,
but go ahead.
But I mean, I don't want to seem like we should just forget it and pretend like it never happened, but like, yeah, I get it. It happened.
It's not our only history.
I agree. Exactly. It is not our only history. And like every time like a movie involving that topic gets made, it's just like, this was the bestest, most emotional waka, 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 blah, blah, blah. I'm just like, okay, like, was it really that good? Are people maybe, is the black community just doing a lot of lip service and just trying to stroke our own cocks to it?
Well, can I say this? At least when
that was just a question. I don't have like an agenda to it.
It's a great question. It's very legitimate. What I want to say though is for this particular movie, 95% or more had never heard of this story. Like just, not just black community, in the black community, just Americans had never heard this story or never heard about these women. It does take place in the 1960s in the South, but it's not a, we're going to show, per se, dogs, you know, coming at black people and fire hoses, per se. That's not the story. It's a story about NASA and these women and what they did and Kevin Costner's. It's not what you're used to. And I would say, see this one, because it doesn't fit the mold nearly like a lot of other movies in terms of the civil rights era. Okay. It's not a civil rights movie.
Yeah, it's about just smart chicks.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. Yeah.
But I agree with what you're saying in general.
Yeah.
I'm just tired of seeing shit that's basically like it's our only thing that happened to us.
Like, I didn't watch. What was the
kind of all that? So,
I didn't watch the Nat Turner one. I didn't watch Nat Turner was the 20 Year Slave one, or no?
No, Birth of a Nation.
Yeah, I didn't watch that. I'm just like, I'm done. I'm tired of it.
I got your solution. Watch Gods of Egypt. There you go.
Oh, how dare you?
It's actually funny. Was it Wale B in the chat? They mentioned about Taj, and I was like, you know what? I think the reason why they didn't nominate her for a Golden Globe.
Taraji?
Yeah. The reason why they didn't nominate her is because if she won, she's on like a lot of fucking TV shows and movies. Like, her value would probably go up, and so Hollywood has to pay her more money.
Hasn't she won already?
I don't think so. Not for an Oscar. I don't believe so.
Yeah, she had an Oscar nominee on her fucking resume. I'm pretty sure she can start acting for a little bit more $1 million for her paychecks.
That's why they got to get locked in those contracts. It's like with Jennifer Lawrence, and that's why she started fucking
dumbass. You got to compare your new to everything ass to somebody that's been fucking acting for 50 fucking years. And then what the fuck is wrong with her
shitty ass performances in those X-Men movies where you can just tell she's just washing it in.
Phoning it in.
Yeah.
She's lazy and she bitches and complains. Fuck that bitch.
I couldn't even like her in
I wish I could though.
I wasn't impressed with the Fappening photos. I'll say it.
You tripping, bro.
I was impressed.
I saw the Supergirl Fappening photos today. Mm. Someone put that on my attention. I was like, wow. Really?
Wait, there's some other?
Yes.
Like, Supergirl?
Yes.
No, that's nothing. I didn't post it. There's a whole video.
I am looking it up right now.
You know what? Just go.
It was a pussy man of steel.
Oh, man. You know what? Go on the wall.
There you go. All right. Booty wall.
Well, you looking that up, we going to march along.
Yeah. What was this shit about Disney and Lucas' statement on Carrie Fisher? Did we already talk about that?
No, we didn't. We missed this. But it was about how when Carrie Fisher died, she had already finished her stuff for episode 8. So people were like, well, she's an integral part to the new trilogy. So what are they going to do since she died? Lucasfilm and Kathleen Kennedy put it out that they're not going to CGI General Organa into the next movies. They're going to figure out a different kind of solution. Maybe write her out entirely. I don't know. They haven't specifically stated, but they did put, to record that they're not going to CGI her into the 8th.
Kylo Ren's going to kill her. Kylo Ren's going to kill her.
Yeah, possibly. Who knows?
Shit, it came up.
I didn't tell you.
Typed up Supergirl.
Oh, you typed.
I'm on the
wall. You got to type in her name.
He's on the wall. No,
he's seeing nudes.
He's watching. Oh, that is her.
Yeah, she's in Homeland.
That's from Homeland.
Well, in Homeland, she's topless.
Yes.
But there's one where she's getting piped.
Oh!
Wait, she's throwing that ass in a circle and popping that pussy?
Her hair is thrown in the wind like she's...
Is this a video or what's going on?
She getting gorilla fucked?
I mean, it's getting the guy... I don't know. It's
is it Terrell
photos.
Suggs going balls
it's
deep?
It's still photos.
All right.
So she's got nice... She's got like B-cups, which are... They're manageable.
Manageable.
This guy really nice.
Like, women everywhere angry at him now.
They're there. I mean, she's super hot, so I'm not gonna. Oh, I know what I'll be doing when I get home. No.
Hey, so for every chick that was just like, that motherfucker talking about her tits, how tall you like your man?
Oh,
look at that. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not saying anything bad about them. They're fucking great.
People got preferences.
Yeah. How much did your titty meat weigh?
Oh, exactly.
There and you go.
Your boy Blue here is an ass man. Because I'm a butt man. Ba da ba 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 ba.
God damn, what the beatboxing? Y'all see this shit on your new shit with Spider-Man Homecoming?
What new shit?
They canceled it?
No.
His continued marathon of hate on King Spidey.
Where's Kevin at? We need Kevin here.
Where's Kevin? Come
here is more legitimate reason to be a hater.
Actually, I can probably find him if you want.
Yeah.
You know what?
So, but here, legitimately, though, there are articles coming out saying Spider-Man has, quote-unquote, way more gadgets than we ever thought possible.
Hey, way more gadgets could be like 4.
Mm.
So,
yeah, it could be 2.
Yeah, right.
If we're talking about gadgets than we thought possible.
Yeah,
that's 2 that we haven't thought before.
He ain't Batman. He ain't fucking Tony Stark.
Oh, I don't
miss me with this bullshit.
Hold up.
In high school,
Peter
Parker. Besides web shooters, goddamn it. Besides web shooters
that are strong enough to help him hold the fucking boat together.
Besides web shooters.
So it's hard for you to imagine that he invents something else as well?
No.
Besides web shooters?
First of all, I respect Peter Parker, goddammit, unlike y'all motherfucking asses. Mm-hmm. But what I'm saying is, it shouldn't be the emphasis of a Peter Parker story in high school. Oh, it's gadgets. It's gadgets. He has so many gadgets. What the
nobody
fuck?
Nobody said that.
There are articles about
this. Like I said, number two,
nobody seen shit.
If he was able to build his own web shooters, what's so hard for you to
he can make other shit?
You made it seem like he built a fucking goblin glider or something.
So then
it sounds like he's going
to
have a
team of hating ass, and so you're making it sound like he's Inspector Gadget.
It looked like they wanted to be Batman. Yeah, they want him to be Batman, goddammit.
I see that on fucking.
What are we doing? You showing porn to
that Supergirl?
Yes. God damn. You're going to get us kicked off of YouTube with your bullshit.
Oh.
Continue on your Spider-Man.
I'm just saying, I don't really give a fuck about gadgets per se with Spidey. I'm just. It ain't his. Yes, he can have some. It's not his.
That's definitely her. Sorry, I'm missing shit on this side of the table.
I got no issue with Spider-Man.
That hurt, yeah.
Extending his boundaries of his inventor and his ability to invent shit and just his
not
crazy crazy shit.
Took this fucking photo.
We got 8 conversations going on. Yeah. Go ahead.
If he's shooting a web ball instead of just a thing and doing some crazy stuff, that's more gadgetry than we're used to seeing.
I don't have a problem with web shooters. But
we don't know. You
better not go beyond web shooters, goddamn.
What is your fear that Spider-Man's going to be doing that's going to freak you the fuck out?
There's a spider buggy.
Yeah, you think he's going to have a spider car?
Yeah, he might just have the fucking spider mobile or some bullshit. I don't know.
The only gadgets I can think of that Spider-Man has is just the web shooters and maybe like the gliders on his suit. That's the only tech I can.
You're talking about the web stuff under his arms?
Yeah, you know how when he's like falling or something, he can like pop open like the web things on the side.
So
if he had
some sort of,
or make parachutes.
Would you be pissed if he had some sort of cloaking type?
Yes,
for Peter Parker. Yes,
I'm just trying to find out where the bar is,
especially when he's still in school. Yes.
Okay.
Like, what if he has Peter Parker Industries? That's way more explainable.
Yep.
Right, but if it's just him in fucking high school, there's no way he's gonna get all that shit.
Okay. If he comes across this, let's say he just fucking...
From Tony Stark, go ahead and say it.
I'm trying to set the bar on where the rage is going to be. So when the movie comes out, I know... I'm like, Prodigy going to be pissed at this.
Mm-hmm.
Chrono's going to be pissed at that. I'm just trying to understand where the levels are at, where your boundaries are set for this.
Anything Peter beyond Parker. His spider-given powers or web shooters in high school, I'm going to probably have a problem with. Anything beyond that. You know, it's just, it seems disrespectful to who Spider-Man is, man. That's, we don't need that for Spidey in high school.
Hey, we don't need these alternative facts.
Oh, there you go.
Fucking bullshit.
We shall see.
All right, what else we going to?
There's a lot of...
What's this Voltron?
Yeah, I was about to say.
I only watched 2 episodes.
So yeah,
fucking watched all of it.
Can we not review the whole thing right now? Because I haven't had a chance to watch it all.
Yeah, I will say this,
Is it better than season one?
It's just as good.
Our first generation Voltron?
I will say... Whoa.
Like the original Voltron?
The original Voltron's kind of cheesy if you go back to it.
It does.
Yeah, so it's still that they do the right amount of cheese like they did last season where it makes fun of itself and a little bit of the older stuff. It's a little bit more dramatic this time around. Once again, it ends on a cliffhanger again. So I'm hoping
setting it up for season three.
Yeah, so I'm hoping season three. And it was just really good. It was really a lot of fun. I was like, this is really good. I super binge watched it over the weekend.
I know you've only seen two, but so far, yeah, concur?
It's the same. I mean, same quality that I expected. So, yeah.
Good shit.
It's not any higher or any lower. So, I mean, okay. I'm very satisfied.
I want a marathon through. It's 12?
Yeah, but they're each half an hour.
Okay.
Except for the very first episode, it's like, I think, a full hour. Other than that, everything else is half an hour.
Good shit.
But
you know what? This isn't Netflix's first Voltron series. There was actually one before where they had like kids. Like, so what? They had the actual pilots of the Voltron things, but they also had kids. So this is kind of based in the future. And like, kids could, like, you can go to school to become a Voltron pilot. Like, there was like a program they can do. And so there were some kids that
was
participated.
This the Voltron Force one?
Yeah, it's the Voltron Force.
Was
that
this
one.
With the cars?
No. This was with the lions. Okay. But what was cool about it is that, like, so normally the black lion forms the head of the Voltron. But in this series, the other lions can actually form the head too. But whenever, like, that other lion forms the head, Voltron uses a different weapon. So, like, you know, like the yellow lion's more like armor based, stuff like that. Okay. They had like fucking mallet. Like the other ones had like a boomerang star thing that he can throw and fucking come back. So yeah, it was really cool to see that different twist to the Voltron series.
So what year was that? Was previously? Huh?
This was like,
and you said on Netflix.
Yeah, this is on Netflix. This was probably like maybe 5 years ago.
Okay,
let me see if I can find the name real quick. I talked about it before on the podcast, but it ended with a cliffhanger, but it never came back for another season.
Okay.
This was this new version of Voltron is super way better. It's really good. There's a lot of crazy stuff that goes on, and they introduce a new character at the very like end of the series, which is kind of weird, but it's still good.
Sounds like y'all approving so far.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Should we tackle the meat and potatoes?
Go ahead.
There's all kinds of meat.
Oh, what is? Yeah.
Well, I figure this will be a nice, good roundtable discussion about. Let's go with topic 11, the women's,
Women's march
that
yeah,
took
go
place
ahead.
And everything. I'm
gonna throw a little bit of shade.
Go ahead. Jump into it.
Yeah, I might offend some of you, but I don't really give a fuck. I think the women's march overall, it was. Premature at the time, but I guess it's not premature because it's kind of fucking up some shit for women. Mm. Potentially. It's not totally there yet, but potentially it could be fucking up some shit for women. But I just want to get some advice and just some overall thoughts on if you're going to march, how you should conduct yourselves. And I'm not trying to mansplain shit to women, but look, I'm sorry. Oh, wearing a fucking vagina outfit and trying to tell me anything, I'm going to immediately ignore what the fuck you're talking about. Like, I don't give a fuck. Like, It shows me that you're immature. Like, you don't see any marches with men with them wearing dick outfits or some shit like that. They'd be fucking ridiculed.
Only in Japan.
Only in Japan. It's like some festival, right?
Yeah,
it's a festival. But yeah, it's... No. But it's... I think people would take that whole march a little bit more seriously if they were wearing, I don't know, something a little bit more... Not professional looking, but just like normal. Like, wearing a vagina fucking outfit or wearing topless shit, it's like you're... People are going to miss the message because of how you look, to be honest with you. And I'm not saying that it's all based on looks, but you look fucking ridiculous wearing a pussy outfit. Let's be honest. Holding up a sign that says some shit about your pussy. It's like, it's fucking ridiculous. And I don't know why nobody's calling them out on the news and shit. You look like a fucking dumbass.
Okay. We're all sort of, in a way, sort of talking out of pocket because none of us are actual women. So.
Well, no, but I can criticize what the fuck I see.
Now,
you know what I mean?
Okay, we are seeing, I mean,
wait,
there
I like,
were a...
I like musicals, so I can...
There was a shit ton of people out there. There was a... I don't know the actual number.
Nobody does. They're making... All the numbers you hear are totally made up. But they're
it was
a lot.
It was impressive.
Yeah.
It was impressive.
It was in, like, different areas, too.
Yeah, it was a nationwide thing in every major fucking city. Thousands of women everywhere were out marching and doing whatever.
Hundreds
now,
of thousands.
Yeah, that's a much more accurate description. Hundreds of thousands. Now, the percentage of them out in pussy outfits.
Probably really
it was
low.
Too many.
Super dog.
It was too many.
Damn high.
Yeah, too damn high.
I'm not going to chastise the entire
message of the march
based on some few outrageous photos.
If that was in my march, I'd be like, hey, if we're talking about men shit, take off your ridiculous fucking penis outfit. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Essentially, okay, that's for Pride Week. We see some people marching in some crazy shit for Pride Week.
But they're not marching for women's rights.
They're marching for gay rights.
They're marching for
pride because they're proud of who they are. And this is part of who they are.
That sort of ties into equality and everything. I mean, you have people that are like, oh, yeah, we're going to make out on this senator's in front of the senator's house to show him that we're not.
And that's I don't get that either. Like, I don't really understand that. Well, like, making out on some dude's lawn for what? Like, you're doing the thing that he doesn't like. What do you think? It's going to change his fucking mind? No.
Well, the thing is that, like, I mean, I'm not preaching to the choir or whatever, because obviously we all, being all African-American black men, we are familiarized with the civil rights movement in itself, and we know that it didn't happen in one fucking day. It wasn't Rosa Parks refused to get on the bus one day, and then all of a sudden shit changed or whatever. The
Rosa Parks thing was actually, that story was wrong. Well, I think we talked about it before.
Yeah. She technically wasn't the first to get removed off the bus.
Well, and she wasn't, like, the story that they told in the history books is totally wrong. She wasn't sitting in the front. She was sitting in the colored section. She was just asked to get
up from her seat because...
Which she did do, and then they asked her to move again, and then she was like, no.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but... People and some people are like, oh, what does this accomplish? What changed? But I mean, change doesn't happen overnight. It doesn't.
Well, according to some of the people that are against Trump, yes, it does.
If you sign an executive order,
it kind of does change shit overnight.
Wait, before I continue, how many of you guys knew that this shit was happening this weekend? Because,
the women's honest,
I knew. I had no fucking clue.
I knew people were going, but I didn't know it was a national.
I didn't know it was a national. I saw some stuff was going on in the city and San Jose.
If it wasn't for the waitress at Lagunitas, I would have not known. I was like,
you were drunk, bro.
Yeah, before I even started drinking.
It was only sort of national. So this is the problem that I kind of have. Another point that I want to bring up is that they're marching for these rights and for women's rights, which they have the same rights as men right now. Okay, they do. There's no arguing that. What they need to do is figure out the 42% of women that voted for Donald Trump. They are not in the places where these chicks were marching. They're in places that are like in the Bible Belt or in the Midwest and shit like that. That's where they need to go march. You marching with your friends in a place that already voted for women's rights isn't really helping. They need to go to places where chicks are still voting for...
To convince.
Yeah, they need to convince them to vote the other direction. So that's the way it needs to happen. Like me telling you, hey, we like the same shit, and us watching around, we like the same stuff in this house helps nobody. You know what I mean? It doesn't.
Okay.
I mean, media coverage wise, it helps a little bit, but yeah, I can see what you mean.
Yeah, if your point is to like shock and awe people with the mass amount of numbers that you can bring, I understand why marching on the Capitol is a lot different than marching fucking in Selma, Alabama, or something of that nature. I mean,
but that's where they need to go. If you disrupt their lives, because
before we talk about disrupting lives, because we all know that. You know what? I'll say it. White people don't like their lives disrupted. None of us like... I mean, yeah. The majority don't like their lives disrupted. If you want to talk about disruption, I mean, marching your ass out on a freeway and blocking out traffic is a motherfucking disruption, and nobody likes that shit.
No.
So...
Wait, you hear about...
Let us pause, pump the brakes on how much of a disruption we want to cause, because... I mean, and we've talked about it before, especially on the sportscast. People thought Kaepernick fucking taking a knee on a sideline of a fucking football game was a so-called disruption for the mass majority of people. I mean, obviously we're in the same few like-minded area of people, but a lot of people were like, "Nah, he can't be doing that. That's so disrespectful." Even though it's silent and he's not talking,
and it took people like 5 weeks.
And I went over it before as a Patriot. You can not stand up all you fucking want for the national anthem. I don't give a fuck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. To just rewind on the whole rights aspect of it, and it's hard for me to say because I've always had the mindset of being a woman I'm not a woman, obviously.
I was about to say, I'm a wait.
I've always had the mindset of if
being a woman, tell us, dude.
Yeah, no. Being a white woman.
In terms of like the whole, I'm trying to motherfucking be serious. In for things like abortion and everything, like that is a complete women's choice that I feel I feel completely out of pocket, like telling someone you need to do this, you need to do that. So I understand why they feel threatened by if they decide to have an abortion in some states where, oh no, you need to go look at the sonogram first before you have this decision. You need to have this sort of counseling and sort of do this sort of shock, kind of like force them to shock and make a decision on that. I think that's a little bit unfair.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
Yeah, and then with the whole, to sort of transition slightly, with the whole Planned Parenthood thing, where it's this misconception that Planned Parenthood is just like abortions are us and everything. Mm. And based on my understanding, like it provides a lot of female services in terms of like healthcare.
Well, not just services. It's like family planning.
They
give out more dick balloons than anybody else.
Condoms, birth control information, morning after pills.
Free though.
It's well, education. Yeah. It really is education, and to see that completely sort of be threatened to be completely defunded, it does. I don't want to say if I was a woman, I don't know how I'd exactly feel about it, but I understand that they're highly concerned based on some of the rhetoric that females have been sort of hearing, especially with this whole so-called Trump agenda and everything. So I have no issue if they want to mobilize and march peacefully, which it seemed like they did with. It wasn't like they were flipping over cars or anything like a team won a World Series, but they were marching in numbers very peacefully. I mean, yeah, some of the signs might have been a little bit highly crash in some of the outfits and everything, but I think it was a. I was impressed by it personally. I didn't really have an issue with it.
So wait, quick question for you guys.
Go ahead.
Do you guys know what dental dam is?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's something that nobody ever uses to eat pussy.
Yeah.
I just learned this fucking yesterday.
Oh my god!
Blew my fucking mind. I was like, they got shit for that? Like, holy, I mean, I knew like you can do like Saran wrap and shit. But like I didn't know like
wait, you were putting Saran wrap
on a movie. Was that on like some Bill Bellamy?
You were putting Saran wrap on pussy.
No, I've never done it. But no,
are you lying?
It was booty call.
Booty call.
You talked about doing that.
Trying to find some dental dam and everything. And I didn't. I mean, at the time, I that was in the 90s. I didn't know what the fuck it was.
But no, like there's it's an actual fucking like you can buy. It's like a condom for lesbians.
Yeah, it's a form of contraceptive.
Boom,
but. Wow. If you need a dental dam to eat pussy, that pussy should not be eaten.
Oh, wow.
I will say...
That's a pro tip.
Juicy J cannot turn down ratchet pussy, though. We know this. I mean, literally all day it's coming at him, and he's just like, you know what? I'm just going to have to fuck this pussy again, or lick it, or whatever.
Hey, anybody who's listening to this podcast for now, in the comments, leave something in the comments saying, like, I didn't know what dental dam was either.
Everybody knew.
This shit's new to me.
Because they said that shit in, like, school.
Yeah,
I don't remember. Ever remember him talking about that in sex ed.
So anybody Holy else's shit. Thoughts on the women's? I mean, because Cronus and I have sort of given our
no, it's all good.
I didn't know about it. That's all I gotta say.
I saw the numbers. You know, I mean, I could see it from both sides. I mean, you're wearing a fake pussy, even though it's a small number. That seems weird, but you know. I'm not a woman. You know what I mean? I like fooders, but I'm not a woman. I have no problem with people assembling for whatever they believe in, even if it's something I don't believe in. You know, that's what freedom is all about in a lot of ways.
Well, I have a small problem, like, sort of with that. It depends on where they do it. I mean, technically, you do whatever the fuck you want. I mean, it's your sort of right? But if I'm trying to get to fucking work and you're actually trying to protest some shit that I don't give a fuck about, or if I do give a fuck about it,
it's an inconvenience.
I'm trying to get to work.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Where you should be doing that shit is, like, probably a State Department. You have a problem with the government, not with me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you don't know how I fucking voted. So you don't even know if I voted for the person that you have a problem with. So get the fuck out of my way.
I don't know where. The D.C. one was what? The Washington Monument sort of thing?
Yeah, fucking blow up D.C. I don't give a fuck.
D.C.? Whoa, you better calm down.
No, wait, wait. I mean, the service about to come. I say blow up, I mean, go there in mass. And like, I'm not talking about that.
Better get our power cut.
Y'all hear that? Y'all hear a helicopter?
No, but there's...
We got a 5-star rating. Not a GTA 5-star.
I'm not sure if it was here. If it was here in California, another state or city, there's like a law that passed that like it's kind of okay to hit a protester.
What?
So basically, if if like you can't just run them fucking over. But like, yeah, if you're like if you're driving and you accidentally like hit them or something, like that you can't get sued by it.
Basically. Oh, can't get sued. Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, fuck that shit. I'm fucking getting my way.
And people get hit all the time. Like I've seen plenty of videos. People just get ran the fuck over. It's like, oh,
like motherfuckers are like walking onto the goddamn freeway. Yeah. Like, how are you gonna go from like 80 miles an hour to like zero just because somebody's walking front? And it's something that you're not expecting.
Yeah. And, but I'm for me personally, I'm not gonna shit on.
I know it's any positive.
Any march or whatever. You know, I don't like violence. You know, in terms of real life violence or whatever, it seemed to be relatively peaceful. Good luck. You know.
So. This leads me into another thing. We're hitting like an interesting conundrum. Mm. All right. So, as we all know, President Trump has already
Emperor Trump.
No, he's just president. So executive orders, just like our last one did, and the one before that, and the one before that. They all do it. All right. So, what I thought about yesterday and today, and a couple of days ago actually, is that what he's doing. Is basically going to make nobody happy, right? Well, it's going to make half people pissed off, but no matter what he does, he can't win. What we need to do is cut the budget, all right? And that's what people have been talking about for the longest fucking time, but nobody's actually fucking done.
The federal budget.
Yeah, the federal budget. But if you look at the numbers last year, we had a budget of, it was like $3.6 trillion. That's how much revenue they got, right? The federal government. They spent over $4 trillion. Mm-hmm. And that's been going on for fucking a long time. Like, way too fucking, like, basically ever since 9/11 happened. That's been happening. We've been overspending our budget. And a president had to come along and start cutting shit. No matter what. It doesn't matter who the fuck it was. Somebody had to do it eventually. And what it came down to was what programs are going to get cut. And so no matter what president, whether they were going to be a Democrat or Republican, it was basically going to depend on, like, was going to show, like, what gets cut. And so people are really pissed right now because it's cutting shit that a Republican would cut. But if it was President Clinton, she would have to cut shit, or somebody else would have to cut shit eventually. Because it would be like this. The easiest way for me to break it down is if you made $360,000 in a year and you spent $400,000 in that year, what would you do?
You would be ass out.
You had no cable this year.
You have to cut shit out. Like,
we're walking to work.
There's literally no way around it. And for somebody to say, oh, why don't they just raise taxes? No. Like, making more money isn't the solution because you mismanaged your money. If you look at any person, the lotto is a perfect example. Yeah, the perfect example. If you're a fucking millionaire but you were poor to begin with, you're going to be poor again within probably 10 years.
Yeah. And like, that's, seriously. There's a huge statistics about that. Like, people who won the lottery, they become poor, like, within, like, 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, you mismanage your money. They miss because they're bad with money. Yeah, like, that's just the way it is.
Yeah, because a lot of people, I mean, this is off topic, but, like, yeah, people that win the lottery, they buy, like, these million-dollar homes that cost, like, $10,000 a month to fucking keep up, and that's all their winnings. It's already fucking gone.
The first thing you should do is invest your money in some, like, take, like, maybe a quarter of your earning, like, quarter of your money if you ever win the lotto, and just invest it in some shit. Find a good CPA, pay him a shitload of money, and then tell him to invest your shit.
You can
and
even fucking, do some of that now.
Yeah, and fall off the grid, too. Like, you change whatever number you have, fucking change that shit, move. Like, you don't want nobody knowing who the fuck you are, because people are going
to
come out.
I'm just interested to see what it is that, what actually programs are being cut, per se, and, like, what ties he has to his own sort of businesses, because I think I've, and I sort of see stuff, like, popped up on, like, little Facebook things, but I can't fucking read them all, and I can't.
A lot of it's bullshit.
I don't have time to read it all and decipher what's a real legit news and what's a real legit site and everything. I seen something about he gave immediately military a raise right off the bat. And from my understanding, is military not the highest expenditure of our budget?
Well, the DOD is a high expenditure, but the military is not. And it was a raise long time coming. President Obama had the lowest raises of the military almost ever.
Okay. Wow.
So a lot of people were like, people in the military, when I was in the military, I lived in fucking poverty. Yeah. Like, literally when I had my daughter, we were so fucking poor, we had to go on WIC, and that's just automatic.
Yeah.
Like, my whole thing is, like, when I see things that, like, get voted down in Congress, like programs to help, like, veteran, like, homelessness and things like that, it's just like, okay, you're saying you're all about helping the troops, but, like, when you immediately cut a program like that, or defund something where it's, like, trying to get, like, mental evaluations for people with PTSD, it's like, What overranks something like that?
Yeah,
like, I'm confused.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So on President Obama, he decided to defund, not defund, but lower the amount of funding to the military. President Trump is cutting things on, like, the arts and shit like that. Things that he doesn't give a fuck about. Just like President Obama didn't really give a shit about the military. Hence, dropping bombs with drones every fucking day. Because it's cheaper, right? So no matter what side you're on, you're kind of fucked. Yeah. Right? Whether you're Republican or Democrat, you're going to cut something that somebody's not going to like. And all so right. I would just hope that people keep that in mind when he goes through all these cuts, is that no matter what, shit has to be cut because we're spending too much fucking money.
You know, one thing I hope, kind of, I mean, this not to be like fucked up or anything, because I feel like us aiding other countries, that should be like a big cut, just so what we can focus like on our own shit, like getting our own fucking like, country together and shit like that.
I don't see what, like, not to sort of cut you off, but I don't see like the logic behind defunding, say, Planned Parenthood.
Yeah, I don't see
but
that either.
We're going to fund a wall. That doesn't make sense to me in terms of like prioritizing like actual.
Oh sure, he's done fucked up shit.
But yeah, I mean, yeah. I'm sure there's things that do make sense, but it's just like, and it just so much information coming in. It's just like I'm still trying to absorb and actually see like what's actually legit, what's right. Just like rumor bullshit.
But it's suggestive, or I'm sorry, it's subjective.
Subjective.
If you're a white male or a white female that believes in the Bible, then cutting funding to Planned Parenthood, you don't give a fuck about.
True.
That's why 42% of women voted for Trump.
Like, I don't give a fuck about this goddamn wall. Like, I really don't. Like,
yeah, we don't. But they do.
I enjoy my friends of a certain
you like
background.
Thick Latinas. That's what you like.
That hook me up with oranges and shit. Like, those are fine with me. I don't see how people out in Central California that are out picking apples and shit like that, I don't see how they're taking jobs away from Americans.
Sorry, let me just jump in. Here's the thing. I would say conversation and talking to people from different walks of life,
I agree,
is
that's
the key to learning about how somebody actually lives. I mean, I agree with what you're saying in general, but there's plenty of people to talk to who can tell you about their lives.
The only problem that I have with illegal immigration is that they're not paying taxes. That's the only problem that I have. As soon as they pay taxes, I don't give a fuck where the fuck you're from.
But
just pay fucking taxes.
But then again, once they do start paying taxes, hopefully our government can use that money wisely and shit, not
spending.
Guess what I'm doing? Yeah. I'm adding more money to my fucking paycheck.
Which is that's basically what the Congress every year, the only thing that they approve is raises for themselves. Right. It's guaranteed.
Yeah.
And there's like a, I want to say, there's a meme going around basically saying how, like, you know, Congress, there's people in Congress that have been there for like 20 plus fucking years.
And that's got to change.
Yeah, and I feel that needs to change because those guys are in there just for themselves.
People really think that, I mean, if you want like actual legit change, like you need to go out and vote on like for your like senators and like people that are actually on your local level.
Yeah.
And not just think, oh, I just voted for person A over person B president wise. Like, they don't understand, like, voting these congressmen and people in Senate, like that's where your laws and everything come from.
Old Ninja, you've been quiet as a fuck. I know you were around during slavery, so why don't you tell us?
He's been fapping a fucking Supergirl. You've been quiet since then.
I can't tell if her pictures are artistic or somebody else, because there's like a third party in the room that took the fucking pictures. So I'm like,
is she shitting on the floor? Because I want to see that.
She's
you got an issue with that.
One thing with
might have to go into that later.
You know, one thing that kind of always pisses me off is with the Department of Motor Vehicles. Like, those motherfuckers be coming up with their own goddamn laws. Like, I've never voted for anything like road related or any fucking. Like, one thing is, like, right now they have
state issue.
Fucking tinted windows, goddammit.
Yeah, like, fucking tinted windows. You can't do this, blah, blah. But then, like, all of our tax money and shit's going to certain things, and it's not fucking being, like, used correctly.
No, look, our roads are all fucked up. Governor Jerry Brown.
Yeah.
He had to declare a state of emergency. What do you call it? State of emergency.
For the roads?
For the roads. Because all this fucking rain. I'm like, bitch, it rains all the time. Where the fuck is all the money going?
Flooding and the shit.
Yeah, why the fuck am I paying 10% fucking taxes for sales tax?
Yeah.
Why am I paying fucking 30 cents on the gallon for fucking gas? That's all supposed to go to the fucking roads.
There you go.
That's beyond the normal state taxes. What the fuck?
Like, gas is actually not that expensive. It's the motherfucking taxes that are on that goddamn thing that makes it so goddamn expensive.
California pays a lot, man.
Yeah, like, it's the federal tax along with the state tax. If you get rid of both of those, it'd be almost a dollar cheaper.
Damn.
A gallon. A dollar a gallon cheaper.
All right.
We got fucking political.
Yeah, we did. Thing. We did. We went all the way there.
Well, the name of the episode is Make America Neck Again.
There you go. What was this X-Men show? Oh, this was the Legion. Legion?
There's an X-Men TV show that a pilot live action? Picked up. Yes, live action. Like,
pilot got picked up by Fox.
No footage?
No. Well, maybe.
Well, we don't know.
Don't know yet. Don't know the cast or anything. Actually, I don't even know the storyline. I just saw like the headline that popped up.
So whatever they pitched, Fox picked up.
So, X-Men live-action TV series, maybe later this year, with the traditional cast or bullshit-ass X-Men?
No idea. There's
a lot of speculation.
No idea.
Because
they're not releasing too much information to the public yet.
Okay, I feel like they're trying to do like with Marvel, what Marvel's doing. Because Marvel's got a good stakehold in the whole TV show game as far as like, you know, basic TV and on Netflix.
You said X-Men TV show? Y'all keep talking, though.
No!
That used to dance around my living room.
It was fucking great. But here's the thing. Oh, here's the deal. I love that theme song. God damn it. If they don't have X-Men, Cyclops, Storm.
They probably won't. They'll probably have, like, Rogue, New Mutants, Jubilee,
Beast,
Professor X.
Nightcrawler, Professor X. If you don't have the household names of X-Men at all.
No.
Miss me with this bullshit, bruh.
Yeah. There's no way that's going to happen. I just, not to be Debbie Downer again. There's no way you can get a TV show budget to have all them X-Men doing all that crazy
shit. They own the license for the X-Men, so now I can see.
They don't even put money into the movies, though. If we're really talking, let's be real.
Money, but they just their creative content.
They gave J-Law a whole bunch of money to not wear a goddamn blue fucking outfit and mope around in a leather jacket.
Yeah, we literally lost Nightcrawler because it was too fucking expensive to get him fucking doing scenes and shit like that. He was the best fucking...
Yeah, he's my favorite.
Yeah, he had the best scene in the entire fucking trilogy of movies or whatever you want to call
them. They spent that money on Quicksilver.
Come on.
How you spend money on just some slow shit?
On some slow shit.
Yeah.
You take a picture and then you have him run around.
Yeah. We just going to slow down this recording film and you just going to walk and pick this bullet out the air.
Remember, the Fox X-Men movie started long before the MCU.
2000.
Yeah. And nobody in the fucking world really gives a fuck about them. Like, would put them on a pedestal and say, oh, this is the higher echelon of comic book movies or whatever. Nobody
I put Blade above that.
There you go. Yeah, so would I.
At the time, we enjoyed it. Or whatever. Because
rewind the tape. Did you just say fucking Spawn?
Spawn?
I just want to hear
it. As a comic book movie.
Actually, I like Spawn, too. I know it wasn't great, but...
It was not fucking great.
It was fucking awesome.
No.
I haven't seen it since, like, 96.
Okay, so for Spawn, that fucking cape was dope as fucking fuck.
For the 90s, yeah.
For the 90s, that shit was fucking dope.
So, to its credit, yes, the effects were great because they were done by ILM. But other than that, the movie's fucking shit.
I gotta go back and watch it because I remember being good.
The tape is dope. The Violator is dope. Because he's played by fucking John Leguizamo. But other than that, the movie's fucking shit.
All right. But I don't have any faith in Fox, and neither do you. I mean, nobody does, right?
X-Men movie or X-Men series? Well, this Legion thing's been getting, like, mind-blowing reviews. Like,
okay. So this is on FX.
Hold on. I'm going to use my crystal ball here. I can tell you what's going to fucking happen. I can tell you that in season two of Legion, if it gets to season two, what's going to happen is it's going to make a magical move to fucking Friday nights. And after Friday nights, they're going to fucking cancel the show. It's going to fucking happen. Y'all heard it here first.
Shit.
Oh, Negro Domus.
I haven't seen anything about it. I've seen, like, news-wise, that, like, Nerdist and IGN, they've been saying, like, it's good, it's really good. Yeah. So I'm like, that makes me happy.
You know what else got great reviews? Fucking Firefly. You know what else got great reviews? Fucking Fringe. Yeah. X-Files. Goddamn Minority Report. Maybe not that great, but that ass was great.
Kapow!
Yeah. It's a long line of fucking great shows that were on that fucking show.
X-Files Almost Human is really good, too.
Yeah, Almost Human. I love that show, too.
I'm not expecting it to last, like, 16 seasons or whatever. I'm not expecting it to be, like, a 24-type series or whatever.
Yeah. Ooh, 24 was,
if
like,
I get four seasons of, like, legit, like, X-Men TV thing, I'm probably happy with that.
I'm only happy if you have some household X-Men name. If you have the B team or the C team of X-Men, then...
You're happy with Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. or no?
Oh, he didn't. Okay,
you're not. You're the fans of Agents. Okay, I just wanted to clarify.
Yeah, I mean, I wish I would actually love Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. from a spy standpoint if they stuck to some of the yeah, but I mean if they stuck to some of the like Secret Warriors or hardcore Nick Fury S.H.I.E.L.D. shit or even Maria Christina Hill doing badass Maria Christina Hill shit, but they don't.
Yeah, well, Christina Hill or Maria Hill shows up twice in the series. Same. Nick Fury's been in it, I think,
like
once.
Yeah.
Wait, but why Nick Fury or Black Nick
Black
Fury?
Nick Fury?
Black Nick Fury.
So, Samuel L. Jackson came in?
Yeah, he came on the show.
The show. No, Samuel Jackson, he's in
Samuel Jackson will get a paycheck. So, you don't care where it's from.
So Lady Sif is in there?
Yes, like, Lady Sif. He'll
rob a McDowell's.
Yeah.
You got snakes where on a plane?
Yeah.
I'm there.
Yes.
That check clear yet? Okay, I'm there.
So Sam Jackson appears twice in season one.
Yeah.
So, and then he...
Well, because the show is built into the MCU, so whatever happens in the movie is part of... It has an effect on the show, so...
Loosely built into the MCU.
Yes, it is loosely. Yeah. But, so apparently this current last week's episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., there's a reference to Luke Cage, I guess.
That's cool.
Missed.
Yeah, they talk about, like, a guy in New York fucking punching through walls and shit.
Yeah,
but, I mean, we all know the gold standard in terms of Marvel live action on TV is definitely what they're doing on Netflix. So
oh, yeah.
Let's be real.
Definitely.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, because if you look at Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., its time slot and its target audience is more
youth,
more family
oriented.
Yeah.
And look, I will say this, even though I don't like the show, I'm glad that it's lasted this long. It's lasted longer than Agent Carter and a whole bunch of other stuff.
See,
it's on network television.
That's what I don't like, is because I felt Agent Carter was a stronger show than Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Well, they were
a lot of people do say that.
They were saying that Agent Carter's coming back, but it's gonna be an animation.
Form.
Yeah, you
yeah,
said
that's
that.
Not that's not the fucking same.
I feel like she, like that actress, could throw that ass in a circle. Though.
She's on another show. On
she's another show where she's a spy.
Is she a spy?
Really?
Or
FBI person?
I thought she was a lawyer. Or some. I don't watch the show, but I know she's on another show.
Does
it's
she
funny
do any
seeing
sitting
her.
On
Haley
the carpet.
Atwell.
Or?
What's with you and?
Oh, sorry. Sorry. It's a family show.
All right. So can we revisit something real quick?
Go ahead.
We're revisiting.
All right. So last week. Yeah, some choice words for Nintendo. Well, not choice words. You're sure you were giving fucking facts.
I did.
All right, give him
some
facts.
He had his broken down notes, and it's hilarious.
Oh, and he brought the notes again.
Wow.
God.
Wow.
Hey.
You had some homeless ass notes on a scribbled ass
Why
piece
is there
of paper.
Urine on there? I mean, what the fuck is this?
This time he typed
like,
up
your note game is a different topic. But go on.
Go ahead.
He typed up his notes.
I'm going to say my piece, and then something at the end is going to just give kind of perspective on the whole thing.
Go ahead.
But. So let's go by the Sony's numbers. Sony's numbers, all right,
mm-hmm.
for console sales, all right. So
yes.
PS1 had 102 million in sales for the consoles.
So
right?
First, what's the topic we're talking about?
Topic we're talking about just console sales.
Okay.
Oh, I might
basically
need popcorn. For this.
Everybody's been kind of all over Nintendo about saying how they're failing lately. And this they need to fucking hit with this console, or they're gonna die, some shit like that,
mm-hmm.
which I disagree with.
Okay. Oh yeah. One thing before you go in, we talked about the Nintendo 3DS. And there's particular games only that Nintendo puts, and that one of them is Pokemon.
Okay.
So Pokemon Black and Pokemon White is only on the 3DS. Big sellers.
Yeah. Go ahead. Well, their handhelds has never been an issue. So, anyway, so let's look at Sony's numbers. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So the PS1 made 102 million. All right. The PS2, which is the highest selling console of all time,
mm-hmm.
155 million.
Yep.
The PS3, how many?
83.8.
No, 57.
That's incorrect.
Even if it's 80, even the 80s, it's almost it's a drop off of almost half.
Big drop.
Nobody talks about that.
No, when you say nobody's talking about that, I would definitely disagree because Sony was eating dog shit those first 2 years. They were getting their ass handed to them.
The first 2 years, but nobody's talking about it now like they're talking about Nintendo.
Well,
let me keep going. All right. The PS4 right now is around 50 million. It's obviously growing every day because it's still out right now.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so it's still well below the PS2 number. The PSP was a for Sony was a great handheld. Was a great handheld.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, 67 million. The PS Vita, fucking not even 10 million in sales.
Damn,
yes,
right?
Complete dog shit.
And nobody talks about that. All right.
Oh, Vita's been shitted on for years.
But nobody's saying that. Holy shit, Sony's in trouble because they're down in sales. Because
well,
they are down in sales compared to the PS2.
Hold on. Wait. Let's not conflate different things. I mean,
it's not different.
No, let me just say real quick, because you had good numbers all the way around. The only thing I'll say is Vita did get shitted on because it got destroyed. There's no doubt about it. But the PS3, compared to the PS4,
The PS4 has been around for a little over 3 years now. It's still growing right now.
Damn, it's been 3 years?
If you look at the number, because the PS3 was on the market for, what, 7, 8 years or whatever? The PS4 looks like it will definitely surpass the PS3. Yeah.
It should, but it's getting surpassed right now by the Xbox One through sales. They haven't passed them yet.
Yeah.
Which we're going to get to more digital numbers, which nobody talks about. And the Nintendo one, which we already kind of talked about. But, yeah, the Wii U was a shitty seller, but, I mean, the Wii still had great sales, and their handhelds have great sales. Like, for instance, their Game Boy, 118 million, which is fucking great. The Game Boy Advance, which wasn't even that fucking great, 81 million. The DS, 154 million. The 3DS, 61 million. That's why I keep telling everybody that when they're worried about Nintendo, it's their handhelds that keep them alive.
But you would even admit, just from your own numbers, and these are some of the same numbers that I repeated last week, the 3DS is their, by far, lowest selling handheld device.
Yeah, but looking at the, compared to the PS Vita, like, PSP.
Okay. The same year, because the 3DS came out in 2012. Hold on, let me just make sure I got this right. No, 2011. You know, that's still a drastic drop and their lowest one ever in terms of their handheld. They're coming off of that and for this.
I actually have a reason for that at the end. And another one that nobody talks about is Microsoft.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's talking about Microsoft failing. However, Xbox only sold 24 million. The 360, only 84 million. And the Xbox One has only sold 30 million fucking consoles to date.
Yep.
And
we shit on Xbox with all that.
We do, but the press isn't. Nobody else really is. Nobody's saying that they're in trouble like Nintendo is.
Well, I mean, maybe Microsoft is a huge fucking corporation. So it's really hard to kind of throw them into that. But they're more than just
Shitty sales can still make them cancel, like they did with the Zune or with any other product they've made.
Well, with Sony, though, like, Sony is a franchise. They sell more than just consoles. Nintendo, all they have is just consoles and games. So if their sales flip, then that's kind of the end.
Well, no, because...
Same thing with, like, Atari.
Well,
like,
they still make a shitload of money in software sales. That's true. Most of the money is. Yeah.
Well, but they have to have consoles and even or handhelds or whatever out there for the software sales,
sure.
Too.
No, that's not necessarily true. If their console fails, they'll be just like Sega and just fucking make their software for the other consoles.
That has not happened, motherfucker.
I said if, jackass.
So you speculating like a motherfucker.
No, I said if their consoles fail.
If is a damn speculation.
Yeah. Okay, okay. Go ahead.
But this is something that most people are not talking about. Mm-hmm. The reason nobody's talking about the overall dip in fucking sales.
For which company?
All consoles. We're missing 158 million consoles out there.
For this generation?
For this generation. There are 158 million less consoles bought for this generation than the previous generation.
But this generation isn't over. Are you talking about the Xbox One
still a shitload.
Wait, but you're talking about the Xbox One and PS4.
No, and Nintendo.
And the Wii U.
All of them. Handhelds included. We're missing 158 million sales of consoles.
And the handhelds are the Vita and the 3DS.
Yes.
For this console generation.
Yes.
Okay. If you're putting all of those together, I put handhelds on one side and home consoles on the other, but even still, I would say the home consoles, the Xbox One and the PS4, are much more in the middle of their product life cycle than at the end, where you would say for the Vita, which never sold, and the 3DS, which came out at the beginning of this decade, are definitely towards the end of their their life cycle.
But you understand that tablets are taking over, and like mobile gaming is taking over.
Oh, yeah.
That's the reason why I have hope for Nintendo, is because the market is trending towards going away from consoles, traditional consoles, to a more mobile market. That's why I don't have a problem with the way that they're doing the Switch, because that's where the market is leading them.
Oh, yeah.
More people are playing games on phones and tablets than on any console.
I've heard that. I definitely have, but
That's where the missing consoles went.
Well, I've heard it, but what I'm also saying, though, is if that's the case, I think we wouldn't see a PS4 as dominant on sales right now. In 3 years, it's already north of 50 million and may surpass PS3 numbers very soon in a year or more. You know what I mean? Like, I agree on Xbox One sucking. You know what I mean? In comparison to the PS4.
But it's still nowhere near the PS2 sales.
So wait, definitely not. Definitely not. Definitely not.
We got a quick drop-off. We got a quick question from the chat room. Jackie asked, do you think that Zelda game being released with the Nintendo Switch might help boost sales with the success of the Nintendo NES Classic?
It should.
It's literally the reason why I pre-ordered the...
And I hear you on that. I don't, but just to clarify though, I don't think the PS4 is going to surpass PS2. I'm with you on that. It could surpass the PS1 though. It could make it all the way to 100 million. It could. It's been very quickly climbing up this list for best console.
Well, so here's another
in terms of highest selling.
Kind of a point that I want to make is that I know we're talking about, we're kind of shitting on
Xbox
last week about them having exclusives, like the lack of exclusives. To be honest with you, the PS4 exclusives aren't that impressive compared to the PS3 exclusives.
Mm.
I mean, honest with you.
But are we comparing...
As far as volume goes.
But hold on, just to make sure. Are you comparing the first 3 years for the first 3 years? Or are you comparing the whole PS3?
Thing. Yeah, whole thing.
I agree so far, but it's just...
Even in the first years, they had a way more...
So you're saying 3 years versus 3 years?
Yeah, okay. They still had way more.
I think 3 years versus 3 years is fair. I do. In terms of comparing those two consoles. There's a lot of truth to that.
Just to jump in here, I don't really feel like Nintendo's going to go anyway, because I feel the Switch is kind of revolutionized, like the shit it can do. Like, it's a fucking portable it's not just a portable console, it's also like a fucking home unit, a home console that you can fucking like hook up to your TV, or you can unhook it, go out and play with it. But then also like the fucking controllers, you can use them like as like, you know, use it as a handheld, or you can like turn the screen into like its own little portable monitor and like play just like looking at the screen. I think it's going to change the game on gaming, in my opinion.
I think so as well. I mean, especially given the trend going towards mobile gaming.
So are you both predicting...
And I'm not a Nintendo fan either.
But let me just say this. Are you both predicting 50, 60 million in whole product life cycle for the Switch in terms of total sales?
It's going to depend. Obviously, the software is going to depend on that. And right now, there's only like 10 games. Yeah. It went up from 5 to 10. It doubled today. So, but yeah, it's going to depend on software, which, as Victor put in the chat, yeah, I'm waiting on fucking Metroid 2, man. I really want that game to come out. That would obviously be a console seller.
And no word about that yet.
I mean,
I want Nintendo. I like the competition. I really do.
Oh, yeah.
I want Xbox to thrive. I want Nintendo to thrive. I want Sony to thrive, because that competition leads to things like trophies coming out. It leads to things like cross-game chat and Xbox Live and all these other things where they're trying to one-up each other. I'm all for that. And I'm not saying Nintendo is absolutely for certain going to be doomed. I'm just saying I think they need a hit based off of Wii U and 3DS being their lowest-selling both handheld and home consoles.
One cool thing I think that the Nintendo has with the Switch is that it's not that expensive. It's like, what?
$300?
$300. And I can imagine a family owning like two or three, just because, you know, the kid's going to want one for themselves. Each kid's going to want one for them fucking self.
Yeah, three's
dude, kids got fucking cell phones.
They offer family plans for cell phones.
But
they
like
first family plans for the Switch.
I think very few households are going to have three of them, even if it's a hit.
When I was a kid, we had two
at
fucking
most
Nintendos.
Two.
Yeah, at most family's gonna have two. But like, just the fact that the kids can play against each other without like having to share the same fucking screen, or they can like in different rooms and like be able to play against each other. Especially like, I think one of the best sellers for the console is gonna be Splatoon, in my opinion.
Yep.
Second, Zelda.
But let me say this real quick. You also gotta remember this, that when it comes to Nintendo, all of our fucking moms and parents and shit called every single video game a Nintendo, whether it was a Sega, whether it was a PlayStation, the name recognition was, if you're playing a video game that's not in an arcade,
you're playing Nintendo.
Yeah. It was synonymous like tissues like, is are to Kleenex. That's how fucking synonymous those two things were. That's not the case anymore, obviously, but my mom still calls it a Nintendo even when I'm playing PS4. You know what I mean? I want to put that out there. They were synonymous with home gaming, period.
Yeah, I think for Nintendo to be really successful, it's for them not to just be in like their own, like into the video game software. Like, also, they should also do like mobile gaming, like stuff that are available on the phone. They should be able to port it over to the Nintendo Switch.
It probably won't be that difficult, but it's really up to them. It's really about what Nintendo wants to allow on their games, not whether if they can, it's will they. That's the real question.
And even the Wii U had some third-party titles. You know what I mean? It's not like it didn't have any. But the console didn't move, you know?
So, there was some news about Nintendo and streaming services. Anybody see this? Like, it may or may not have Netflix or some bullshit like that?
Well, yeah, it's not going to have Netflix at launch. So.
They
yeah,
can add so, that later.
Yeah, the PlayStation True. Didn't. The PlayStation 3.
PlayStation 3 had one of the worst launches I've ever seen in gaming history. I mean, coming off the PS2... It was $600. It was super expensive.
They got cocky, I think, and they just thought they could just.
But people were buying it.
No, that's motherfucker.
The PS3?
No, not at launch. Goddammit.
I bought it at launch, but the most majority people of people yeah, the did back. Not. Yeah, I was trying to defend
PS3 at launch.
Yeah,
at 20 because it was expensive.
Oh, yeah, I was like, what?
Yeah, I'd buy it at launch.
Yeah, because it had the four USB ports and everything.
It also, like, has an SD, it also had the SD card slot, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it was that price tag, too, and the launch library that people were like, I'll wait.
Do you know what extra games were added to the Switch that's going to be released during launch?
You should add that.
I know it was 5, but it got changed to 10 today.
Pull it up.
I don't know. I didn't even see.
I wonder if Alexa streams. Knows.
God damn it.
Let's ask Alexa, see if she knows.
But I'm not shitting on Nintendo, per se. I want them to thrive. I just want them to... They just got to hit a home run. I just want them to hit it, you know?
Yeah, I want them to, too, because I'm actually pretty excited about the Switch. Like, I actually might pick it up.
I'm reading through the comments, and Victor's saying they can miss them with the whole charging for their online service.
Ooh. Oh, yeah, fuck that shit.
But what are they offering with their online service? And, like, because essentially isn't...
So Xbox does, is they charge for online services.
Yeah.
So does... Well, PS4 sort of does.
Yeah.
PSN sort of does.
Yeah, so I'm kind of going to confuse... Like, did I miss something that Nintendo is...
I thought you get a game. I thought you get a game per month or something similar to Xbox Live or PSN.
Oh.
Or PS Plus.
Well, I wonder if it's... You know, it'd be cool if they have, like, their own, like data service set up where, like, you don't have to go to your own fucking your wireless carrier or some shit like to get the internet and shit like that.
Well, I would like for people to not... There are some people who have literally bought the same game on the Wii, the Wii U, and possibly on the Switch.
That's what I did hear. What I did hear was, like, supposedly on this service, if you buy the game, you only get it for that month. Where, I did actually hear
that's fucking retarded. Yeah.
Where if you get, like, for... PlayStation Plus or whatever, even with Xbox Live.
Yeah, once you buy it, you have it.
Yeah, once you buy, like, Rocket League, if you get it on sale and free that month and you save it on your thing, you're good.
It's always yours.
You're good as long as you're paying
for it. As long as you're paying for the service. I think with Xbox, you're good. Once you have it, you have it.
Yeah, once you have it, you have it, and you can download it through, like, now you can do the whatever the fuck they call it, where you can play it on a Windows 10
machine. Yeah, the PlayStation one, you have to still be an active subscriber to PS Plus in order to access whatever games you previously downloaded. Supposedly, what I was hearing from the Nintendo Switch is, like, you only have it for that month. So, essentially, if you download...
That is bullshit.
I just use Rocket League for an example. It's like, oh, yeah, Rocket League is the game we're giving away for the month of February. You only got it for February, then it's gone, which I think is bullshit.
And let me say this. I know we have collectively shit on PS Plus, and it has been dog shit in terms of the free games per month compared to the old days in PS3.
Yeah,
no doubt about it. But I will say, in, like, holiday season time, and I know they do a sale in the spring and in summer, whatever, basically once a quarter almost, the discounts
alone... The sales are better than the actual free game that they toss your way. It used to be...
The sales are legit.
Like, the past 2 days, there was a huge sale for, like, $5 games.
Yeah, yep. $5, yeah. Flash sales.
I mean, they shut me up with fire some of those sale? Cheap games. Yeah, the fire sales. And the holiday season, the whole last 2 weeks of December, it was nothing but great sales.
Yeah,
what do you got online?
Okay, I got you now. So these are the launch titles confirmed right now for March 3rd, which is when the Switch comes out. It's The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, which you already knew about. 1-2 Switch. Just Dance 2017. Skylanders. Imaginators.
Yeah, Imaginators.
Super Bomberman R, which is probably gonna be a really fun party game. Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus.
Afterbirth.
Yeah. Gross. I Am Setsuna, which I heard was a pretty good RPG. World of Goo, Little Inferno, and Human Resource Growth Machine.
World of Goo. Right.
And the other ones, these are the other big ones that are coming out later. Is Snipperclips, which I heard looked like it was okay.
What'd you call me?
Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, ARMS, which looks like a lot of fun. Splatoon 2, which is going to be a big seller. Fire Emblem Warriors, Pokemon Stars, Super Mario Galaxy, obviously that's a fucking system seller. Xenoblade Chronicles 2, which is going to be a good game. And a new Fire Emblem in 2018. So, yeah.
Most of those other ones you mentioned are confirmed for 17 or nah?
All except for the new one, the new Fire Emblem. Okay. Fire Emblem Warriors is 2017, but the next one is not.
Do you ever see the porn parody for Splatoon?
Oh, the store party game. Shit, there's a lot.
I know they have Skyrim coming on there, too.
Yeah, there's a pretty comprehensive list of third-party games, too, which is good. Good start.
Dude, a lot of the Splatoon, like, hentai stuff online is just nothing but fucking, like, what's it called? Bukkake?
Bukkake,
yeah.
Oh,
damn. But that's basically what the fucking game is. You're just going around just fucking throwing paint at everybody.
Sounds like there are fooders. Yeah, right. I like it. All right. Did we step on your final?
No. I mean, that's it. I mean, I just want to say that, you know, everybody wants to put the pressure on Nintendo when there's other console makers that are having the same problem that Nintendo's having.
I have hopes.
Basically, you're calling out Microsoft.
Well, no. I mean, Sony as well. They still have, they're not going to meet 155 million since they're a big console seller, you know?
Not 155. I agree with that. Yeah. But 180 million plus is big.
And they literally just had a console fail. The Vita failed.
And
I love the fucking Vita.
I love it too. The Vita failed. There's no doubt about it. I'm not going to argue with that.
But nobody's talking about Sony fucking failing and shit.
Well, the thing about it is,
Sony's playing with house money.
Sony didn't even mention the Vita during their own expos. PlayStation exactly. Expo, they were like, But yeah, the Vita failed.
I mean, meanwhile, look at the last E3. I mean, we made fun of it because Nintendo basically only announced two games.
Was it two?
Pokemon and Mario?
It's Pokemon and Zelda. What was everybody talking about in E3?
Pokemon.
No, they're talking about Zelda. The vast majority of people were talking about Zelda.
The thing is, and I've heard some people say, like, Zelda really technically isn't a console seller, per se, in terms of, like, the units that they've got. And I did some research to look up the numbers. Like, the most popular Zelda game only sold 8 million units, which... Ooh. Yeah.
Which one was it?
Twilight Princess? I put it... Yeah, Twilight Princess is the most popular Zelda.
Dude, that game was hard.
It came out on
two
systems, though.
Yes. Yeah, that was the combined supposed. So both? Yeah, and it totally threw me for it. I did a little bit. I looked it up because when it got brought up, I looked it up again just to remember because when I heard it the first time, I was like, "That's a really good point." And I know you being a Zelda fan, I wanted to get your input on it.
Even more than because Widow Waker, I think, was only on the queue.
About Wind Waker? Why do you keep saying Widowmaker?
I don't know.
Because he got a list, bro.
No, because I keep thinking Mass Effect and the Widowmaker and the Sniper.
So you're talking about Overwatch.
That's totally different. Now I'm not talking about your fooders.
Yeah, because I mean, and I can't remember. Like, I'm not really good with memorizing how many units a game sold and everything like that.
You can always look it up.
I mean, if it was eight doesn't sound like a system mover to me.
It's not Grand Theft Auto V.
Grand Theft Auto is in its own separate category tier. Well, but like something like I'm trying to think of something to compare it to. Like let's say Skyrim, for example.
Well, you have to look at the title. You have to look at the game and when it was launched, because Twilight Princess came out towards the end of the GameCube's life cycle.
But it came out on the Wii, too.
But so it also came out on the Wii.
I'm looking at it, and he's right. I mean, it sold 8.58 million. Yeah, that's across both consoles.
That's odd to me.
And the Ocarina of Time, which is
my favorite,
one of the best games ever made, only sold 7 million. Mm-hmm.
So
like, I don't know how to contrast that to, because that number alone, I didn't know what to compare it to.
So
in terms of like other gaming, I didn't know if like it mattered because of the platform or anything. But so what technically is like a system seller sort of number? Like we've talked about like
it's
records
a good question.
And everything being like, oh yeah, this music record sold a lot. And like, obviously we know that like Grand Theft Auto V like blew shit away with its however many millions it did in
billions
3 days type shit. But like in terms of like actual legit units pushed, like we never really have those numbers. It was like all we really do talk about is like, yeah, that game is good, but we don't know. I don't know how many units Arkham Knight sold off the top of my head. Like, yeah. I don't know how many.
I know that he's got like 5.
Yeah, I just know it's good. I just know we just
you
sort
looks
of
like you got a list over there, bro.
Yeah, I will.
I'm looking at Mario games.
Yeah, I will say this. Typically, when Nintendo launches a system, it is launched with a Mario title.
Like, okay. For example, let's say, what was the Pirate Assassin's Creed game? How many
Black
units
Flag.
Did that
oh,
sell?
Black Flag. That was great, yeah.
Two.
It was just a question. Well, I don't know.
So that brings up two good points.
Okay.
One is the fact that it's across multiple consoles.
Okay. Yes. So if we could get the unit for just that
automatically
one,
is going to outsell them.
Okay.
Second of all, unless you're talking about a Wii, the other console has outsold them. So they're already going to have a bigger platform for any other multi-platform game.
Yeah.
Okay. So how do we...
There's no way you can really quantify it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
It's challenging.
Okay. I want to know, because I can't think off the top
of
my head.
Even like an Infamous? Or?
Is this the first Zelda game that is a launch title?
No, was the original Zelda launch? No. Remember that gold fucking...
The original Zelda?
I feel like that came out in 85, 86.
I want to say Zelda came out before Mario.
No.
I'm calling bullshit on that.
Yeah. No.
It's just in my memory of the 80s.
Those games were... That was the game they tossed you with. It was that in the Duck
Hunt
cartridge.
Yeah, when you bought
cartridge.
The game. Yeah, yeah,
and also remember, it came out in Japan a year and a half earlier. Yeah. But yeah.
Yeah, because I can't think of if Zelda launched as a launch title. Usually, I remember it came out like around the Christmas time.
And Zelda is, I will say, it's a beloved franchise. Since
I don't want you to go back and pull it up, but what number did Mario put out for, I guess, the units sold that Mario did?
Which
if
Mario?
You remember.
Well, the highest one was like 40 million.
40 million, yeah. Okay.
Was that number three, or?
No, it was like the fucking first one.
Okay, so 40 million is where the bar is at.
But
hold on.
Wait, 1 second, though. How do we, are we taking out... Are taking into account things that came as a bundle, because Wii Sport is going to be way up there because
it came with the Wii.
It came with the Wii.
Sorry. Okay.
All right, you know what I mean? So bundles are interesting.
Well, it was only bundled at first. The original Nintendo sold over 100 million, right?
No, 60.
60? Okay. Well, that's pretty good saturation then.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, are we always saying it's okay to include software titles in terms of sales when it's bundled?
I mean, it's still a game. You know,
it is.
It'd be like saying you can't count Tetris as being one of the highest selling games of all time.
Yeah, Tetris is definitely up there. I just wanted to put that out there because some people don't like to include it. But...
So yeah, so Super Mario Brothers came out in 1987, September of 1985.
Yeah,
sorry.
If we could pull, I'm going to try to pull up a unit list
and,
number for Nintendo.
The Legend of Zelda came out in February 21st, 1986.
So it's only like 5 months from apart.
Yeah, they were close.
Yeah, but that's...
All right, we've gone way down into the weeds.
Deep in
gaming,
we're
learning like history lessons and shit.
There we go. But no, it's fun. What was this bullshit about? Oh, god damn it.
Well, before you talk about the bullshit about blah blah blah, I wanted to go back to like
holy shit.
I wanted to go back to like Marvel's TV shows. You guys hear about the whole Dagger and Cloak?
Cloak and Dagger.
Cloak and Dagger.
Yeah. Yes.
I heard that they were getting close.
They have their actors.
I heard that they were getting close to signing them, that they weren't officially casted.
Oh, I thought they signed them up.
I haven't seen anything about
official. Is this their own television series, non-Netflix,
yes.
So, on what channel?
On Freeform, which is formerly...
The fuck is that?
It's formerly ABC Family.
Oh, yeah. Fuck the show, then. but, like, it's interesting, because I saw that the kid that played... the kid from Heroes is actually playing...
Oh, yes. He's playing
Dagger?
Cloak.
Oh, yeah, Cloak.
And Dagger's the girl. The
girl.
I don't. I remember. I've seen. Oh, the girl's from Disney Channel.
Yeah, she's from
Jessie.
Like,
I don't know.
It's. I mean, I don't. So we were talking about this on the before and after the before the cast, and I feel like they're just really trying to like pull money from like comic books. Like, there's so many comic book shows out there right now. Like, we have what CW and the DC's doing. We got like Arrow, Flash, Supergirl.
We got more coming.
Gotham.
So we
Lucifer.
Have.
Then Marvel, they have fucking Age of the Shield, Luke Cage.
We
got Constantine up in there.
Constantine's supposed to be coming back.
We got Teen Titans. Oh, wait, sorry. Golden Eggplant.
Oh, you motherfucker.
I don't understand what you just said.
But no, I kind of feel like they're really like trying to pull as much money as they can from the comic book
world. I don't see anything wrong with that. I mean,
it's all about the execution and who they choose.
But I think it's going to go like... There was like the time where like it was all about like the fucking werewolves and vampires and shit. Like,
yep.
I feel like it's gonna be oversaturation. And I think people are just gonna get fucking tired of this shit.
Well,
same with like reality show. I think reality shows have reached your plateau and they're slowly going away.
Well, just to go back
Thank
to
God.
Cloak and Dagger or whatever, it's a really dark story. Like,
it is.
It gets into some teenage.
I really like it though.
Yeah, it's interesting, but it's dark. And what I'm saying is, I doubt Disney Channel XD or whatever the fuck it
Freeform.
Is going
ABC
to
Family.
Literally talk about the drugs, talk about the teenage sex, talk about the biracial stuff, talk about anything that's real from that actual story. Mm-hmm. They're just going to gloss over that shit. I know it.
I don't know. I don't watch anything on Freeform, so I have no idea.
Well, I watch shows on ABC Freeform, and they get pretty deep with like like emotional type shit or like, you know, like drug related type stuff. It's like it's like the Hallmark Channel. Like they just have like documentaries that talks about like such and such families and blah blah blah. So okay. I mean, if they want to go like dark with it, I think they might be able to do it as Freeform. How successful it will be on there is it's hard to determine. Cause I don't see a comic book that dark and deep being successful.
It's
going to
be up on a Friday night, and
so the real question is. Is this going to be part of the MCU?
I would doubt it unless it becomes a hit. You know what I mean? And then they could write in some ties with Jessica Jones or Luke Cage or,
yeah.
You know, or something with Ant-Man or whatever. But it has to be a hit, man. And they got a big... Nobody know. Basically, if you don't really read comics and shit, you don't know who the fuck this is.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
I didn't read any of their comics, but I've seen them pop up. Like, they're in Civil War and...
Well, they're in the animated. They're in the animated Spider-Man shit,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, the Ultimate Spider-Man.
But they pop up with cameos. Yeah, you know what I mean?
And I know that they were kind of... I don't want to say big, but they're integral in the original Civil War. Because that's how Captain America side they used Cloak to him to teleport everybody when they're in danger and shit.
All right.
So, I don't know.
We going to get to some goddamn comics?
Are we?
Yeah, let's see some.
Let's talk about some controversial shit about comics. About ooh, that fucking idiot that was talking about Miss America being the new LBGI.
Better get right. We were talking about it last week.
LBGT.
Let's just call her this.
The new like gay character in Marvel. First of all, you stupid fuck.
Who's the first one?
Well, she's not new.
Yeah.
All right, she's not new at all. She's been around for a long time. Like, 2011 was when she first came around. That was fucking 6 years ago, you fucking idiot.
Yep.
And second of all, like, her being gay isn't even a main thing in her story. She just happens to be gay.
I never knew it, and I read a bunch of her
stuff. Yeah, me either. I didn't know that either. But it's like, I'm sick of these stupid-ass, quote-unquote journalists trying to figure out something that's new. They're like the hipsters of journalism. Like, oh, yeah, it's new. No, it's not. It's fucking old as shit.
Yeah,
it's like saying, did you know that Iron Man had a drinking problem? Yeah,
yeah, exactly.
Fucking 30 years ago.
Did you know Batwoman was a lesbian?
Yeah.
Jesus.
I think she's getting her own title later on this year. And that's fine or whatever. We'll see how successful it will be or won't be. But yeah, calling her new, like, I was like, this is nails on a chalkboard. You obviously don't read any fucking comics. She's an interesting character, don't get me wrong. But her sexuality isn't all that important to me or most people anyway. But yeah. But you want to talk about your pool, or are you busy?
Oh, no, sorry. Somebody was talking about some shit.
All right.
It's getting heavier and heavier,
yeah,
y'all.
Yeah, what you got over there?
So this is a $93 fucking pool.
God damn it.
All right.
God damn.
Catch up on these motherfuckers. Saga came out today.
Oh, shit.
One of my favorite comics of all fucking time.
Yes, yes.
And the end of this one is kind of fucked up. And they did something that I haven't seen before in a comic.
Which was?
Whereas, the last four pages are just black.
What the
I'm not going to give away the ending, but
it's like
some
Sopranos type
it's,
stuff.
Yeah. It's kind of fucked up what happens in the end.
There we go.
That's like some gem shit.
Two of my favorite things ever in the same form. Slayer and fucking comic books. It's a Slayer comic book. So I picked it up.
Is that number one?
Yeah, it's number one. It could suck. I don't fucking know, so... Blue Beetle, which I need to catch. Oh, actually, no, I am caught up on it. So
I like it.
It's been pretty cool so far, but I need to start like cutting down my pull, so that one might get cut.
So wait, who's your favorite Beetle?
I like Jaime Reyes, but
yeah, he's my favorite too.
That's the only one that I know. Jaime Reyes. Are you talking about the Green Beetle or like
the Blue
Black Beetle.
Beetle? Blue Beetle.
Oh,
there's like the original was like the white guy. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I like Jaime Reyes. It's pretty cool. Civil War: The Oath, which is hopefully aftermath of Civil War II. New Black Panther, number 10.
Very nice.
Inhumans vs. X-Men, number 3.
I gotta catch up on that.
Yeah, some more Star Wars shit. Thanos, which I've been looking forward to.
Did you already read that one?
Not yet.
Okay.
The only thing I've read was Saga.
Okay.
So I had to prioritize. Infamous Iron Man, which is a great Iron Man comic.
Look, I love it, man. Yeah. I've talked about it.
But once again, if y'all didn't know, it's not Tony Stark. It's
Dr. Doom.
So... Thunderbolts, which has been okay. It's been decent so far, but it might get cut. If I need to start cutting down this shit, I can't spend $100 every fucking week.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, I could, but it's been on something else.
Like Shippus.
Yeah. Punisher comic. Totally Awesome Hulk. Looks like they're finally done with that fucking Jeremy Lin goddamn bullshit.
Jeremy Lin?
I'm like, what the fuck?
That shit was awful, man.
Playing basketball and shit? Get the fuck out of here with that nonsense.
And with one of the worst players in the NBA, I mean, he's ghetto good, but he's not.
He's ghetto good. Damn.
God dang.
Are you talking about Santa because he's Asian? Racist?
No, no. If he was balling, I'd get
Deathstroke, which is one of Prodigy's favorites. The Flash. Wonder Woman.
The hell? Wait. Is she in like a straitjacket?
Yeah.
You know, that would be a good fucking story twist. It's sorry to be like.
Crazy. Like, damn it, Snow. What?
Well, no, there's
also. Word it with the two X's?
Yeah, the two X chromosomes. Yeah.
Good. But no, there's like an alt world story with Batman where he's actually. Like, Bruce Wayne is actually fucking crazy and he's inside an asylum, or Arkham Asylum, and like the Joker, Dr. Joker, is like the person that's overlooking him, and like. There's a fucking twist to the whole storyline. Sorry, go ahead.
A new comic that came out called The Odyssey of the Amazons, which is events happening on Themyscira before Wonder Woman.
So ooh, I like that.
Isn't it like a couple thousand years before her or something like that?
I don't know. I haven't read it yet, but...
Killer Frost.
Yeah. Check it out.
She's got her own pool? Her
comic, yeah.
Nice.
Batgirl, this one's probably going to get cut. Because I read like the first two and I wasn't really impressed.
Yeah.
So.
Still, yeah.
And it's like it's just a girl because I have plenty of fucking girl comics. Shut the fuck up.
But they have vagina costumes?
Yeah. Well, that's why. It's just now called Bat Vagina and I can't stand for that shit.
Like, I feel like Batwoman has a more detailed or like deep storyline for her versus Batgirl.
Yeah, I mean, I think Oracle has more of a storyline when she was Batgirl, but you know, this, I don't know. I'm not into it, so it's all right.
You like what you like.
Yeah. Batman Beyond, which is actually a fantastic comic.
Yes!
The end of number 3 was like, holy shit.
Yeah.
And this is number 4, so I'm really looking forward to seeing what's going on in this one.
Loving that one.
That animated series was fucking great.
Yeah, it was. I canceled too early. Reborn, which is a great Image comic about after you die, these people go to like this like fantasy world.
Yeah.
So like there's like an old lady that dies and she ends up being reincarnated. Well, not reincarnated, but she just like, gets transported as a younger version of herself in a fantasy world. All so, right. And people that she knew that died are there too. So it's interesting so far. The quote unquote Hulk.
Jesus Christ.
Because we already have a Hulk.
Jesus Christ.
Is this a She-Hulk?
And the first comic book, she didn't fucking Hulk out. So this one might be a quick cut.
I mean, don't get me. I like She-Hulk as a character.
Oh, so
but...
do I. But now she's got PTSD and shit.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
What?
She didn't get fucked. Well, Thanos fucked her up.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Yeah. It wasn't from Civil War. It was from. Actually, it kind of was. Suicide Squad versus Justice. I'm sorry, Justice League versus Suicide Squad.
Get it right.
This is six. This is the last one. And then Justice League versus Suicide Squad again, huh? But this one's a Suicide Squad.
With their fucking naming conventions.
Fucking
well, maybe it's like they're like giving a point of view from the other side, I guess.
Well,
same fucking book, but just from different point of views.
Well, it's like they're usually like tie-ins, so it's just more of the story. It's just like it's kind of confusing, but the story's good.
Yeah,
okay. It's just the fucking covers are stupid.
They are. Well, they're trying to purposely fool some people, which is bullshit. Nobody appreciates that shit.
Well, yeah, because if you come home and you get the wrong one, and you're like, what the fuck happened in the last...
Yeah, you're like, what the... Yeah.
Yeah.
Then a week goes by, they all sell out, and you're fucked. And then you have to go on fucking my... What is that one website where it takes forever to fucking ship you goddamn comics?
Amazon?
It's like My Comic Books.
Oh,
or
yeah.
That's a great site, but it takes forever to get your fucking comic books.
Yeah. I will say this. I am enjoying, even though I didn't read your Venom Space Knight, I like the new Venom quite a bit, at least the first two issues.
Yeah.
It impressed me. I wanted to read more of it. It's a brand new guy, but we'll see.
Well, I think it looks like the other guy, Flash, is coming back.
Yeah, so that's what Eton over at Cape and Cow was telling me. I'm intrigued. Go ahead. What you get, Stitch?
No, I was going to say real quickly for because we're probably winding down. Just want to throw out the there's sort of two topics kind of winded into each other with the whole Dog's Purpose thing.
Oh, yeah,
and Ringling
ahead.
Brothers.
Well,
say, thanks for putting them both together.
Yeah.
Well, no, I was going to say, like, before you did that, since we're on the topic of comics... So I don't mean to step on your toes, but like, it's been on the list for a while.
What you got
about the whole like Miles Morales getting his own fucking cartoon?
Oh, I'm excited for that.
Yeah, go ahead. I mean, I love it. Everybody loves it.
Oh, I mean, that's pretty much it. So, so on with the show.
Okay. Well, yeah, it should be great. Yeah,
like I know a lot of the Spider-Man cartoons has been really good, so I'm really excited about the whole Miles Morales thing. So, yeah.
I think it's definitely a good way to get a lot of mainstream people that like don't read the books or know anything about it. Be like, why is Spider-Man black now? Or whatever. They've just been living under a fucking rock
For Spider-Man.
Exactly. So I think it's a definitely a good way for to get people, especially younger people, into Miles Morales that aren't reading the actual books.
And they've set the groundwork in the Disney's Ultimate Spider-Man, where Miles has made many a cameo over the course of the last few years.
Yeah, he has a different power set than Peter Parker.
Definitely.
So, yeah.
He's not just a clone.
With the Venom sting and the
invisibility.
Invisibility, yeah.
And like he gets his web shooters from Peter Parker, like the Peter Parker of his universe.
Yeah, he sort of like inherits them. Yeah.
Does he have cool tech from Tony Stark, though?
Not yet, but he might get some from S.H.I.E.L.D.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, sorry, go ahead.
All right, so yeah, so back to...
Okay, so there's, I guess, a controversy going around with A Dog's Purpose. This movie, I'm an obvious avid dog lover.
Same here.
And everything. It's a dog movie. I sort of avoid these dog movies just because I don't really get caught up in the field.
What was that one that was sad as fuck?
Yeller?
Marley and Me. Yeah.
That fucking movie. God,
I didn't watch that. I knew better.
Right? Yeah, it was sad as fuck.
Yeah.
Get back in here,
that one's sad. I get caught. I can only watch the first half of like I Am Legend because I get caught up with that. We're having a German Shepherd and everything. And that whole second half was just like whatever. That Ren 10 Ten, all those dog movies.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
But
was it like what was the one with the two dogs and the cat, and they have to like find
Milo and Otis. No. Homeward Bound.
Yeah.
Homeward Bound. But there's Milo and Otis.
But then there's like a sequel to that one too.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
We have a dog. Black and Black. Tom's Infinity loves dogs. All cats right. Not so much. No. But
unless they're.
There's a movie with, and I can't think of the actor's name. He's in those baseball movies all the time. The main
Dennis Quaid,
yeah. He's, I guess, in this movie with this dog that sort of, I guess, they sort of have this premise that dogs sort of get reincarnated. I guess there's no dog heaven; reincarnated to different dogs.
I just saw this trailer last night.
Yeah, okay. And like people are hyped about it. Supposedly, I guess there was some leaked footage. I guess during the filming of the movie where this German Shepherd was just constantly thrown in the water that didn't want to be in the fucking water.
Freezing water.
I didn't know the concept of it because I'm not gonna go for clickbait watching an animal get so-called tortured and everything. I'm just gonna save myself the being mad video about it. Now what was, because you said freezing water, I thought it was like a wave pool thing where you didn't want to be in.
It was basically a wave pool, and they had like jets over here that was like pumping water to make it look like it was like rapids and stuff like that. And the dog trainer was trying to put the dog into the water, but the dog was like struggling, like I'm not getting into this fucking water, no count. And he didn't.
Now were they mad because they put the dog in the water? Or was the dog actually like struggling for his life?
No. So the dog was struggling not to get into the water. Like the dog was like pawing at the wall to pull, and it like literally pulled itself back up out of the water. Like it barely got like a foot into the water. It was like pushing itself back out of there, and eventually the trainer had to like kind of. I don't say he threw him into the water, but he like
threw him into the water.
Yeah, he pushed him to the water.
Did you watching it without outside noise, did you think it was cruelty watching
it? Just seeing the dog like obviously the dog didn't want to get in the fucking water. I was like, damn, this is fucked up, like why are they doing this shit? But like the dog basically went from like that wall to that wall, and there's like a diver in there, there's like people that was there to protect, make sure the dog didn't fucking drown. Was like a kiddie pool.
So do you think it was more overreaction, or do you think it was actually warranted? Just you personally.
I felt bad for the dog. Like, that's emotionally, I felt bad for the dog. But, like, it's like a kid that doesn't want to get on a roller coaster. But then they get on a roller coaster and they're like, oh, this was, like, the funnest thing ever. But then again, it's like, you can't read what... No, that's... So, if you have kids...
Get these rip-roaring rapids. Oh, this shit's fun.
No, that was his best word. If you ever try to get on a roller coaster with a little kid, they're like, no. It's, like, even me, so... Funny story. So back in the day, when I first time went to Disneyland, I was gonna get on Space Mountain, the one that's inside with all the lights and shit like that. I heard people screaming. I'm like, no, I am not getting on this. I fucking started crying, and eventually later on, I actually got on. And I was like, this is the funnest shit ever.
Okay,
but no. So like, that's basically what
you want to see it.
Yeah, you can play it. But
yeah. So Cronus is throwing up right now.
Stitch, are you gonna cry?
Nah.
It's just a quick.
I know the dog lives, so I'm happy.
Yeah. Yeah, so you see just the dog struggling. I don't think he's been thrown into the water because he's dry.
Well, we don't know what
it's just churning water, after, so but... is the water.
But it's if you like watch the video, like it's not like it's like fucking like crazy water rapids and stuff like that.
That's all this bullshit. Just show
Well, that's part of the movie, but the thing I will say is supposedly, and I haven't seen what happens before or after or any other clips, the dog did not suffer, or obviously wasn't killed, didn't, you know, go unconscious, didn't get quote unquote hurt.
Like there's like there was literally a somebody in a scuba suit or like a I guess like a lifeguard or whatever.
Where's my super suit?
But like the dog, like they swam over there to the dog real quick and pulled him out of the water. Like this is like this. It's hard to even say like that's fucking Jets. It could be like fucking like.
Yeah.
So not abuse for you is what I'm hearing.
It's hard to say because the dog is scared. He doesn't want to get in the fucking water. And he fucking like pretty much throw the water in the water.
I understand like the dog has no concept of Hollywood or whatever. Yeah. So I'm sure. And my dog absolutely loves water. He loves getting bass and everything like that.
White water though? I don't know if it. But most dogs would avoid white water.
Yeah. That's a little bit different. The dog doesn't understand that like, yeah, humans are here to protect me. He just like, nah, my animal instinct says like, I don't want to be here.
Yeah.
I don't see him punching the dog or anything. I mean, that's a little bit kind of...
Yeah. Well, he pulled him back out.
Yeah.
It doesn't look warm and loving.
There's a person in the water, like, there to get the dog.
Wait, so what did y'all say? I heard your opinion.
That's a little bit rough. That when the dog goes under like that, that's a little bit rough.
So y'all saying animal abuse, is that what I'm hearing?
That dog went under.
What do y'all say?
I'm not saying animal abuse. I've heard and seen a lot more shit that quantifies abuse.
Okay, so
than that. That's not animal fighting. Gotcha. That's not a trainer punching the dog in the face because it won't sit.
Or kicking.
I've seen video of like dog groomers beating dogs and doing more violent shit than that.
Oh okay. Yeah.
So I'm not gonna word it as sort of that.
But anyone the one else's interest, thought. What I was gonna say like the movie's been fucking pulled. Like, it's not going to be shown in theaters now.
What the fuck? Really? I didn't know that. Wow.
They're reconsidering when to release it.
So, PETA got a hold of it.
I thought PETA was there for this entire thing. Normally they have... Yeah.
PETA does not want a fucking dog doing shit in a movie.
But I thought normally anytime there's some sort of, like, heavy animal acting...
Humane is there.
Humane Society
They need to chalk it up with them. Like, if you had your representatives there to oversee this entire movie...
PETA should not have a representative on a...
Well, yeah, not PETA, but... The Humane Society. Yeah, yeah. They're like SPCA. The ones that'll whoever it is the body that governs
ASPCA.
Yeah. Like the purpose for this movie, the premise of this movie is really good. Like, you know, like dogs being reincarnated and like they try to find their owner again.
I ain't
like
that's
the whole
that.
Premise of this movie is really good. But this whole little thing is really throwing a little fucking damper in the movie.
All right.
And then real quickly
even watching like the trailer makes you want to fucking tear up a little bit.
And then real quickly with the Ringling Brothers is closed. I've never been a circus kind of guy. I enjoy going to zoos and stuff, and I sort of talked about it at the time I brought your son to the zoo and everything. I think it's really cool how like the San Francisco Zoo, they have a lot of animals there that would not be able to survive in the wild because they're injured and everything. They have like bald eagles that have like an injured wing or that's blind in one eye, and or animals that have sort of been relocated just because of some sort of illness, or they were just completely abandoned, which I think is really cool, rather than just taking like a random healthy ass. Oh, we took the biggest, baddest lion we found and put in this motherfucking cage and everything. So I thought that was really cool.
But no, there was
circus
fucking
stuff. I'm not really a big fan.
But no, I was gonna say at the San Francisco Zoo, there was that one fucking like cheetah or leopard or lion or some shit that got out.
Yeah.
It fucking attacked somebody. But that person, they fucking needed that shit to happen because they were like taunting the fucking animal.
All right,
yeah.
Yeah, I'm actually glad that it got shut down. Like, if you want to go to a circus, go to Cirque du Soleil. It's way more awesome than Ringling Brothers or any other kind of fucking animal type of, you know, circus.
But it's like 100 years of circus just going on.
And it's fucked up. It goes to, you know, neglect and abuse. Yeah. They were proven track record of it. That's why they got shut down.
Yeah, which sort of, I mean, obviously they can't just release these animals into the wild. So I'm glad that they have zoos where hopefully they put these animals into, because Ringling Brothers is just like a traveling fucking situation. Yeah. They can't just be like, all right, go in this preserve now, tiger that we've had since 5 years old that knows how to balance a ball on its fucking head. All right, go fucking learn how to hunt zebra and shit. Like, that shit will get...
Survive for yourself.
You're not going to be able to learn that shit. So I'm glad like certain zoos like take it amongst themselves to take like injured animals and make it more of like a refuge and habitat more than just like having it be a dog and pony show for, hey, look at this big bad thing that we got.
All right. You know, it's kind of interesting, like, the whole, like, animal cruelty thing is, it's actually having a lot of effects, like, this last year, because, like, SeaWorld got rid of, like, the whole killer whale or the orca exhibit, and fucking, finally, the Ringling Brothers is shutting down, so yeah. I
mean, all right.
Fucking some kind of impact.
Fucking Telecom died, all kinds of shit.
Let's round it up.
Well, did we really want to quickly talk about TV shows just real quick? Because DC TV came back this week.
I didn't watch anything this week.
No one said that.
Well, yeah, nobody else watched it then. Although I watched The Flash, Supergirl, but.
Yeah, I watched Supergirl, but.
Save it for one more week.
Huh? I watched Gotham. What? You guys got to watch that shit.
One more game.
One more game.
Old Ninja, what you got going on this week? You've been quiet as fuck.
Wait. Before we go, we talk about this whole Jay-Z twin thing with Troy Aikman?
I have no idea what this was.
Oh, you haven't seen this shit?
Yeah, pull this shit up, man. This shit's fucking hilarious.
Troy Aikman, the former Dallas Cowboys quarterback in the 90s that won 3 championships, looks like the white version of Jay-Z.
What type in Troy Aikman, the first thing that comes up is Troy Aikman, Jay-Z.
Yeah. it's a spot-on thing.
Like, that's how fucking big this shit is.
His nose, his lips.
But Troy Aikman's commentator now. I see him, and he don't.
I know what Troy Aikman looks like.
That.
Watch this shit.
Holy shit.
How about now? Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Nose, lips, eyes.
I stand corrected.
Yes. They look spot on.
Yeah. So everybody can see.
All right. The half and half is really
scary.
Yes.
It's like funny. Dave Chappelle doing the white guy that's a news broadcaster.
Pretty much.
That's pretty fucking weird. It's weird.
And nobody ever noticed it until like this past week, basically.
And it's been fucking blowing up the fucking internet.
They look the same.
That's weird. Hilarious.
Man, that's trippy. Yeah. All right.
I mean, obviously, the lips are a little smaller. But yeah.
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 Old Ninja, what you got this week, goddammit?
So I'm trying to see if I can make it to the Crunchyroll Awards, which is happening Saturday night in San Francisco.
It's free.
It is free. Open to
if you have a premium account.
Yeah, so I think it's $5 at the door, as Prodigy was saying.
Yep.
Catching up on some shows, because Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. came back like a couple weeks ago. So, it's been 2 weeks, so I got to catch up on the current episode.
They've been killing it, too.
Yeah, DC TV came back, so I'm pretty current. Arrow is on tonight, so I'm going to watch that when I get home. We find out if this is Black Canary or Black Siren. So it's going to be pretty interesting.
Yeah, I might watch that tonight.
Yeah, I'm going to be doing some more gaming. We've been slacking on our gaming as a podcast, so I'm going to see.
For co-op collectively, but...
Co-op collectively, yeah. We've been gaming individually on different things.
Well, let me know next time you guys play Division, because I need to jump on that shit.
Get on every night.
Get on with me and Hobby and Stitch.
Yeah, because I believe the Division... I think it was Hobby who posted that Division's releasing more content in the next
month
or so.
They're expanding the map. From what I hear,
so it's going to be more.
The dark
shit.
Zone's supposed to be a lot larger. Prodigy got his
the
first
rape
case
zone.
The rage zone. See,
shit.
Prodigy got in the dark zone.
Yeah,
everybody else is level 30, and I was like,
safe.
You violated the first rule of the dark zone. You cannot go in the dark zone by yourself.
No, we were squatted up three.
You was up three.
He wasn't ready.
But their level like jumps everything else.
Yeah.
Okay.
I used to go in dark zone by myself. Dicks off.
So yeah, that's pretty much it. Actually, I'm probably gonna try to see XXX this week too.
Oh god,
so, wait, is that a porno?
I'm gonna watch more porno, man.
Yeah, well, I mean,
you got a problem, bro.
No, it's the Xander Return of Xander Cage.
Oh, Xander's a foot. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh god, dang. And then more porn after that.
All right, Blue, what you got?
I'm gonna go home tonight and flap to this fucking Supergirl shit.
Oh,
goddamn,
that's my girl.
She gonna be my girl.
Like Fifth Harmony said, that's my girl.
Is she popping it though?
She's gonna be my girl for the night. Cause goddamn,
if you have not seen these pictures,
God, I should have kept my mouth shut.
Shit.
I mean, it came up eventually.
Y'all didn't know shit about that. That was out for a while.
It was on the wall, man.
It was on the wall, but not like this. This is her taking deep dick in, and I'm like, this can't be real. Because it looks like it was shot for, like, a magazine.
Oh,
almost.
God.
But yeah, so...
So basically, you're masturbating this week, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Might be. I don't really know my business. But this weekend I'm going to another. So the reason why I did Lagunitas because there was a free Spartan training thing at a gym up in Petaluma, which it was cool, but it was nothing like the actual fucking Spartan race, man. Because like the wall kind of like when you
the booty wall.
So when you jump up, no, not a booty wall. But when in the Spartan race, when you climb up a wall, like there's tech, like there's grip to the wall so you can like grab yourself up, but this shit was like particle board. It was like fucking smooth, so when you ran up it, like your foot would slip and you try to grab onto the top and your hand would just slip off.
Yeah.
So it was a decent obstacle course, but it wasn't the real fucking thing.
So where I do a jiu-jitsu at there, they just got their Spartan training like thing. So
license?
They,
oh.
Yeah, so they're like a Spartan, was it GTX or whatever, yeah, certified. So if you want to do actual Spartan training, you can go there.
And that's at Newark, right?
Yeah, it's in Newark.
And what's the name of your...
Koa Fitness? Koa. They have a pegboard. It's fucking awesome. Have you ever seen those?
Oh, yeah, but in, like, the fucking board, you're like...
Yeah, it's fucking hard as shit. Yeah. But yeah, they got a pegboard, and they're building a wall. But they're going to do just general fitness for Spartan races.
Wait, they are they building a wall and making taxpayers pay for it?
No, they're making Mexico pay for it. What are you talking about? They're going to get it right.
We're paying first, Mexico, and then yeah, Mexico's going to reimburse us.
Yeah.
They're going to reimburse us with illegal immigrants. Yeah. Get some free labor.
And avocados.
All right, Carlos,
so wait,
you got? Oh, sorry.
And Lemon Pledge.
Go ahead, Blue. We stepped on you. What you got?
No, nobody here. No. So, yeah, so other than what, the fabling, the fucking working out.
This motherfucker's like, I'm working out and fabbing. Yeah. All right.
Shit, what else am I doing this weekend? So I'm going to try to catch up on the DCU stuff that just came out this week. I'm trying to catch up on Voltron. Hopefully I'm trying to get into get more back into Division because I fucking hate it. That's like one of the first game I actually rage quit. I was like, you know what, this game keeps fucking glitching and fucking up on me all the time. But I'm gonna try to. So I talked about this last week, but I'm gonna work on the video footage for how to edit video on VSDC for our podcast. I'm gonna release.
I need to watch that shit.
Yeah, I'm going to release how to do the React video, and then next week I'll probably do the podcasting version, because there's two different videos, and they're all, the way the videos are done is different, so.
And after you release yours, I'll do how I do the podcast.
All right, nice.
Like how we record, how we go live, all that shit, so.
And one big thing I want to try to do is I want to try to set up my VR, because I haven't used it in so fucking long.
Me either. There's a bunch of new shit out for it. I just haven't played it yet.
We watched some reviews on some of those games, too.
Like, it's cool because, like, especially for having, was it OBS?
Yeah.
Like, I can actually try to record, like, my gameplay and try to do, like, kind of a review of what I'm doing. So hopefully I can try to do something like that this weekend.
You could do it with XSplit, too. That's why I broadcast it before. But yeah, OBS works as well, because it captures whatever's coming in.
Well, VSDC does it, too, but it's not that great.
Yeah.
But
I like the way that, well, because it's easier to do it through like streaming programs, because you can put where you want shit on your screen. If you're doing like just a video capture, it's kind of different, right?
Well, something I learned is that you can actually like move the box of what's being recorded. You can actually change it if you hold the control button and then click on like the little green box that circles the image.
Yeah,
you can move it around, because I would use it on a chat roulette.
All right,
that shit's still around. God dang,
chat roulette is not chat roulette that you think of anymore.
Sure,
it's,
it ain't.
It's just fucking online webcam
fapping.
All right,
Kronos, what you got for this week?
I gotta go into jiu-jitsu. I got a badass new like daddy accessory. Because I'm gonna go into like some daddy shit real quick. But basically, everything for fucking babies is basically built for women. Mm. It's fucking annoying. It's another thing I don't ever hear fucking feminists talk about is equality for goddamn baby shit. Because there's nothing that's anatomically built for men. Well, it's not nothing, but there's very few things. And one of the first things I saw was that I had a baby carrier from Ergo Baby that actually Mishka got for us.
Nice.
And it's great for women, but not for a dude. So you wear this thing, and it basically holds the baby on like your chest, but it holds the baby like super low. Yeah. And so I was constantly getting kicked in the fucking dick. I'm just like, just like the way it's like built is just like not for a man.
For a chick.
Yeah. So I'm just like, what the fuck? So I had to go out and find one. And luckily, I think it was Mr. X. He had posted on my timeline a while ago about this thing called the Mission Critical Baby Carrier. And it basically looks like a fucking bulletproof vest.
Yeah.
And it holds the baby way up higher.
You got to take a pic in that.
Yeah,
and show
the audience. I have. It's fucking, it's,
oh, yeah, you tweeted out too.
Yeah. It's one of my favorite. Yeah, I did tweet it out. One of my favorite new baby accessories, because it holds it up high. Looks fucking badass. I love it. And then I also got like a Thule running stroller, which I'm going to use pretty soon, which is like, it's fucking expensive, but it's cool.
Nice.
So, yeah, other than that, catching up on my comics. Got to get some gaming. I've been playing a lot of Final Fantasy 15.
Nice.
Past game, obviously, but I'm going through like all the hunts. I'm just trying to get higher up in levels. I figured out kind of a way to kind of level hack in the game. So if you guys are playing Final Fantasy 15... early on in the game, like one of the first places where you can like quote unquote sleep, it's like super expensive in the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
But if you sleep there, it doubles your XP.
I was gonna say, can you fuck like hookers and shit?
No, no, no. So in the game, it's kind of weird because
Westworld.
In a normal RPG, if you're playing, like when you get experience points, it immediately goes towards your level, right?
Mm-hmm.
But in this one, you don't count your experience points until you go to sleep, right? And so it's kind of weird, but it's also kind of like a little thing you can do to kind of hack the game, because certain places where you sleep ups the amount of XP. Like, you can get double the XP points, right?
So that's kind of like in real life. Like, if you work out in a gym, like, you don't see results. You don't see results until you rest. You have to, like, rest for, like, you can act so the muscles can recover.
Yeah, you don't get gains until you rest. But
XP, though?
I mean, you get... Yeah.
All right.
But anyway. Essentially, if you stay at a Holiday Inn. Yeah.
But anyway, if you're later on in the game and you have, like, a lot of money, which I had a decent amount of money, if you go back to one of the first places where you go to, it's called Golden Key or something like that, it costs, like, 10,000 gil to spend the night, but you get double the XP. So I was just playing the game and, like, just racking up a bunch of XP, and then fucking I would get, like, 30 or 40,000, you know, EXP points, and then I would go there and just double it. So I'd get, like, 80,000, which is, like, a fucking shitload of experience points in the game. So I went up and I went from, like, level fucking, like, 50 to, like, fucking 64. And
the,
like,
cap is 99?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
But I basically gained, like, 14 levels within, like, a day.
You're still not fucking with the big turtle?
No, it's like fucking level 99. It's a goddamn mountain. Yeah, I'm fucking with other shit now. But I'm just like, when like literally the mountain came to life, I was like, bruh. And like, trying to run away from this thing was fucking terrifying.
I just hear the song, like, you're the best around. He's just like level up, sleeping so he can take on the big turtle. Because I know he's going, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to take on the turtle. I'll switch that a bit. Yeah. Like, okay, I'm turtle.
Please do.
Yeah, and there's other things too. Actually, it's not just a turtle. It's like that.
Shit.
There's like other things that are bounties that are level 99. I'm like, I don't even want to accept the contract.
Wait, did you Twitch your fighting against a turtle?
No.
Oh, God damn it. I'm going to try to see if I can find footage, and I want to do that. I'm going to take your fucking the song, have somebody like try to fight him and lose, and like just see them like sleeping all the fucking time, getting like health and shit.
Oh yeah, if you're trying to fight him, I have no doubt that one
get like little Mac running.
Yeah. 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 I wish I could do like cool video editing like that.
I wish what I wanted to do though is cuz like later, so in the game, what I was going to complain about in my review was that there's no fucking flying device.
Oh yeah!
Like, every Final Fantasy, there's a fucking airship.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But in this one, there wasn't an airship, right? Until after I passed the game. Apparently, you can upgrade your fucking car to a flying car.
The fuck?
And it looks badass.
That's fucking cool.
And it was, nice. But one complaint though is that apparently it's kind of hard to land.
You just fucking crashed.
Yeah, and like I didn't know because it said okay, preparing landing sequence. It's like okay, so I keep flying, but apparently when it says preparing landing sequence, it means you have to start landing now.
Oh.
And so I'll just start, and I just fucking died. And okay. So one time I put on autopilot, and it said starting landing sequence. And so I started landing sequence, and I started going down, and I fucked this landing up, dude. Like, literally, my car flipped over, it went on its side, kept skidding, but it just went upright and just kept going. I was just like, what the... It was like a super glitch.
Did the boy band die?
No, they're fine. Yeah. Anyway, yeah.
No, so I want a full, like, separate, almost like you did for Batman Telltale, for just this game. From you?
Yeah, I could do that.
That'd so be wait, awesome. Before we go any... Can you grab Alexa real quick? I want to do a quick Easter egg thingy. So, tell Alexa to enable your mama jokes.
Alexa, enable your mama jokes.
Okay, I've enabled it. It may take a minute until you can begin using it. To start, just say, Alexa, open your mama joke.
Alexa, open your mama jokes.
This skill is not enabled.
Gotta give it a second.
Right, give it a minute.
Say enable a your mama joke skill.
So wait, yeah, wait, okay, somebody else go. What's your...
All right, okay. Stitch.
Pretty much, just recently I watched the little Slender Man documentary that was on HBO.
Ooh. Wait, documentary?
Yeah.
They're also doing a movie, too.
Yeah, it's about these girls in Wisconsin who believed in this Slender Man thing off, Pasta Wiki or Pasta something or whatever. I forget what it was called. And they ended up killing this other, not killing, but they stabbed this other chick like 19 times and everything. And so like they're in court, but they're 12-year-olds, so they get in this whole concept of like, should they be tried as adults, blah, 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 blah. Which,
if they were black, though.
Yeah, watching the documentary, like, and it was interesting because I had never heard of fucking Slender Man
really?
Or whatever. I was just like, that thing is creepy. I was like, it's like, that shit better not be real or whatever. Or like, they're trying to make it sound like it's Bigfoot, like Slender Man out here walking around.
Like,
in the
like I say, play that shit in fucking VR. That shit's fucking scary.
Not doing it. And so essentially, I think it's just shitty parenting.
Yeah.
During a shit ton of times in the documentary, They just essentially give the iPad to the kid and just let the kid, the iPad raise the fucking kid.
Damn.
Which I think is a problem because then the kid has no reference of what's actually real or not or whatever. If they just read everything that they see on the internet and on fucking meme boards and shit like that, maybe they think that this Slender Man motherfucker is real and they need to be sacrificing other people to it. Because essentially he's sort of like this boogeyman kind of thing. So it was a sort of interesting thing. I thought it was a little bit too long because it's like an hour 45 minutes. I thought it could have been done maybe like an hour just to say what was going on with these two chicks and what was going on and what they did and the whole Slender Man concept and blah, 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 blah. The other thing, just real quick, House of Cards is getting pushed back. Normally it comes out in February, but it looks like it's coming out in May. Hurts my heart because I look forward in February watching Frank Underwood dominate and do some real boss type shit.
When y'all gonna review that shit?
Dude, there's four seasons.
I think he just finished.
I just finished.
Yeah,
I
so we need to collaborate.
Solitary fuck. Get together and review that bullshit.
Yeah, let me know and I can like record
it. Yeah,
and
we need your help with that. Yeah. I took my car to get oil change, which was funny because...
Panda, right?
Yeah, the Ice Bear. So, I normally you get your car changed around like between 3,500, 5,000 miles and everything. So mine was like, had like 4,600 miles. And like the engine light comes on, and I freaked the fuck out because I was like, engine
it's
light.
A new car.
Well, it's all on miles.
Yeah. So back in the day, my very first car was a Nissan Pulsar, 1988 Nissan Pulsar. I didn't think I had to change the oil until the oil light changed.
Really?
Came on. I blew the engine, that motherfucker.
God damn.
Yes. Yes. So I see the engine light come on. I panic. I'm like, what the fuck? I was like, I got warranty and I bring it to the place because it came on the day before I was supposed to bring it because I just knew. And I can see, like, it gives me, like, an oil life percentage and shit. Like, if I go to, like, their certain menu. And he's like, oh, yeah, no, the engine light will come on when it says it needs oil. I'm just like, God damn, they're just idiot-proofing all these motherfucking cars.
My car? So I've had the brake light on for, like, fucking 5,000 miles. Because I was like, first, it came on, and I was like, okay. But normally the way I can tell I turn my brakes is when you start feeling the brake pedal, right?
Yeah.
My brakes are fucking fine. 5,000 miles, fine, all right? It's still on because it has these fucking locks on my wheels that I can't fucking get off. And I went to like a tire shop and I'm like, oh, those are BMW locks. We can't get those off. And I was like, you have to go to BMW to get them.
Yeah, of course.
Motherfucker.
And they're going to jack you up for price. Yeah. So that was a little bit of a funny thing. And then last week I was supposed to issue a correction because Lilo had been fucking around talking shit on Earth Girls or whatever. 2 weeks ago on Earth Girls, Lilo said that I put a picture of my dick on her fucking background. She was wrong or whatever. I found a black dick and I put it on there. And I've been giving her shit. I've been giving her shit the entire time or whatever. Cause like she was in the shower getting ready for work. And I was just in my goofy. I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna fuck with her. And I just like typed up black dick or whatever. And it was painful to sort of search because you're looking at
no what are you
you're like, oh, this was nice and long and veiny.
I was just like, all right, this one, boom, 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 set it. And I went to, because I was working like midnight, so like I get home, she's going to sleep.
Did you pick one with foreskin or not?
It was a circumcised dick like mine. And I just put it on the background or whatever. Well, 2 weeks ago on Earth Girls, I'm listening, and she's like, yeah, he put his dick on there and took it for the... I'm like, I ain't sending out no dick pics. There's no... Stitch has not sent out a dick pic. Not to his wife. No. Not to nobody.
Not today.
Yeah.
Not today.
Not today.
Dick pics are it's a very time important to part go. Of relationship. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Never on a Sunday.
Yeah.
That's Jesus Day.
Yeah.
Prodigy, on the other hand.
Yeah. You send Ashley dick.
Ashy, no lotion, dipped in chalk.
I told her, I was like, you need to correct that shit. I haven't listened to the most recent Earth Girls yet. But
she has
I'm
not corrected it.
Yeah, I'm going to get out here. I'm going to give her shit when I get back to the house. That's be like, I told you.
Putting it down,
bro. So, what's the thing? What are you talking about?
All right, tell Alexa, open your mama jokes.
Alexa, open your mama jokes.
I can't find that
skill. Oh, all right, so wait there, no, it's still there. Yeah,
section of the Alexa app.
Say, Alexa, tell, or Alexa, open mom jokes.
This skill is not enabled.
It's not ready yet, though.
Enable it. Say, enable your mama jokes skill.
Alexa, enable your mama joke skill.
This skill is already enabled. You can use it by saying, Alexa, open your mama joke.
Alexa, open your mama joke.
Yo, mama's house so small, she eats her meals off a dime.
Damn.
Do you want to hear another?
Yes.
God damn.
Yo, mama's house so small. I threw a rock through the window and hit everyone inside.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
That's fucking brutal.
Pretty good. She's fucking savage with it.
Hold on. Real quick before we end this fucking podcast, did you look at the thing that I posted on my page about the
Cashmere
Outside?
Yeah.
I've actually seen this episode.
Yeah.
Oh, for y'all that are listening, y'all can hear this. I don't think it's going to be copyright or anything, but here, just...
Wait. Before you play it, though, like, that girl just recently got her ass fucking beat, right?
She did. She got her ass whooped because she was a fucking disrespectful bitch, but this is a kid that basically is a shithead to her, like, her parents. Basically, it's like a... Remember that episode with Cartman where he's like, whatever, I do what I want. That's this bitch.
Yeah.
So somebody made a song out of this chick talking the about Cash Me Outside. Listen.
Catch me outside, how about that?
Catch you outside?
Huh? You never seen this?
What does that mean?
What I just said.
It's somebody putting a tape in a tape player, pressing play,
I think back.
And turning it up. And this is from Napoleon Dynamite.
Awesome.
Just listen.
The song is fucking great.
Yeah.
How about that?
The fucking dance is like perfect to it too.
It's like a
trap music.
I love the eyes.
It's all Vader and shit.
I love people do that shit.
I love the remix shit with that hood. Good ass memes.
Catch me out. Wait. Cash me outside?
Cash me outside.
How about that? All right. We rounded it up. I'm going with Old Ninja, hopefully, and Stitch to Crunchyroll. I'm really looking forward to that. And that's all I really got, except for trying to catch up on comics.
That's Supergirl, though.
Hit us up on binhabproductions.com. Please use Twitter and hit us up at BeethanBTI.
That's BeethanBTI.
Yep, Facebook group. We got, leave comments on the goddamn SoundCloud and then YouTube. Subscribe, smash.
You can email us at BeethanBTI@gmail.com. We're also at BeethanProductions.com/ BeethanBTI.
Check Instagram. Us out. Twitch.tv/BeethanBTI.
And if you have an Alexa or an Echo, just ask Alexa, like, hey, let me hear the program beat Blacker Than Black Times Infinity, and she'll play us for you.
Well, no, you have to say...
on TuneIn.
Yeah, play BeethanBTI on TuneIn. Oh, sorry, play Blacker Than Black Times Infinity on TuneIn.
I like it.
Oh, okay. Well,
because she knows where that Dankness is from.
I actually never tried that.
Goddamn.
Alexa, play Blacker Than Black Times Infinity on TuneIn.
All right, took too long. Shit. Say Alexa, program, our podcast.
Play Blacker Than Black Times Infinity podcast... Bitch! Cut me off!
Say, Alexa. Play podcast.
Oh, shit, I fucked this all up. Don't worry about it.
That was all good.
Alexa, stop.
So yeah, you say, Alexa, play podcast Blacker Than Black Times Infinity on TuneIn, and she'll play us. You can have us in your ear hole.
Radio Disney.
Alexa, stop.
God damn.
Oh, we fucked this up.
Yeah.
All the way through our goddamn outro music. What the fuck? We're not professionals.
Hey, let's do this one more time. Yeah. We're doing it live.
Appreciate everybody in the chat, y'all.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Jackie, because I know you on the East Coast. It's late as fuck.
Oh, shit, yeah.
What about long?
And all our Brazilian listeners.
Hell yeah.
Hey, we hit fucking 3,000 on Face on YouTube.
Way over 3,000. Well, not way over. But
wait, we're over 3,000.
We're at 3,030 right now.
So we're moving on up.
We're out of this bitch.
Peace.
Take it easy, y'all.
One more time.